Yeah. ESL Pro League is brought to you in part by Logitech G, Pay Safeguard, Mountain Dew League, and ESEA.
G'day guys, and welcome to the ESL Pro League North America Division. It's match day number 16, and I guess we're kind of halfway through match day number 16 already. We've already seen that first match between SK and OpTic going on over on the mainstream, but now for us, it's actually our first match of tonight. It's the only match that we've got tonight on this stream. OpTic and
Cloud9.
I was missing it for a second. I had a bit of a brain fart, but we got there in the end. So OpTic Cloud9, it should be a good one here. And I mean, particularly considering we've just seen OpTic having a very, very good match actually against SK, picking up at least one of those maps that was train. It was close.
It was a 16-14.
It was 16-14, but it's still a win.
Exactly, it's a win. And OpTic going to be very, very happy with that because train, it's always been a good map for them. It's always one that they play very well on, and they're proving that. Of course, it's been a good map for Cloud9 as well, but to beat SK on a map means that you're probably a pretty proficient team on it.
Oh, definitely. And we know that they're fairly decent at it. They've had generally pretty good results on it so far this season as well. We're having a look at the standings in general through the season. SK having now lost their first game up against OpTic Gaming, or the first map, I suppose, but still sitting up there in rank number one. OpTic still looking okay here as well, moving up a little bit courtesy of that victory today. They could move up a little bit more depending on how they go against Cloud9 at the moment, who's currently sitting in second position. So overall, I mean, I'm not hugely surprised to be seeing anything on those standings there. Would maybe expect to be seeing OpTic just join the ranks of some of those other teams, get themselves up at least one more win today. Hopefully for them, at least they can go with a 1-1 against Cloud9.
That would be the plan. I mean, energy in third is interesting. Maybe not expecting them to be as high
Maybe
up,
not.
But very good play from them. And SK's round difference is insane.
Yeah.
Plus 94, that's a very clear dominance from them. And of course, being 13-1. But Cloud9 being up at the top of the standings is expected. You know, last season they did have that flawless group stage.
Yep.
So they're always strong in the group stages of Pro League, or at least in more recent times they have been. So 9-3, not as clear of a dominant standing that they had last time, but still playing very, very well.
Yeah, definitely still looking pretty good. And you got to remember, though, that they did play in the last week of Pro League without Skadoodle, where I think they went down 0-2 actually to Misfits. Maybe they probably would have 2-0'd Misfits if Skadoodle was in that roster. I certainly would have thought so. So potentially, you know, they could be a little bit higher had things not gone the way that they did. Very, very similar to what we saw from SK last season, actually, where they had a player swapped out for a couple of weeks and Renegades was able to 2-0 them back in Season 4. So maybe it's some sort of a similar situation coming out here for Cloud9, but I don't think it's going to affect them all that much. I mean, they're still sitting up there quite securely in second position, and they'll be probably sitting there for the rest of the season as well, I'd imagine.
Yeah, that's usually where they are. They're usually up at sort of top of the Pro League standings. They did have that, as you said, the games where they had Valen standing in for Skadoodle, and they went, I think it was 25-23 and then 16-4 to Misfits, which is not results they would have normally had, especially against a team of Misfits caliber. Not that Misfits are a bad team, but Cloud9 normally expecting to be more dominant in this stage. But that's a 0-2 where they didn't have one of their core players. They can sort of forget about that, move on, get into the rest of Pro League.
Yeah, definitely. And we'll see how they go tonight up against OpTic. It is going to be maybe a bit of a difficult game considering, because we've got, obviously, OpTic in fairly decent form at the moment. Cloud9 still fairly good as well. But to me, both of these teams coming into it with decent form, so I don't think it's going to necessarily be a hugely easy task for either of them here to get a 2-0. Definitely possible, but I'm not sure if it's going to happen. So there we go. That's our schedule for tonight. Having a look over at how things went between SK and OpTic. 16-14 in the favor of OpTic on train. 16-7 in the favor of SK on Inferno. Now we're going to see OpTic up against Cloud9. And it's a tough night, really, for OpTic, isn't it? You have to go up against number one and number two in the standings.
It is, but if they can get some wins against number one and number two, they're proving that they are deserving to move further up into the standings, to move on from the fifth place in which they currently sit. So if they can get some wins here, if they can go 1-1 with Cloud9, if they can tie it up, that'll be good for them to be able to go further on and make their case for the higher, to be placed in the higher echelons of the Pro League teams.
Yeah, definitely. So be good to see whether or not these guys can have a good performance tonight. But yeah, I mean, I have to think about sort of how they've gone against each other in the past, OpTic and Cloud9. They haven't actually played each other, I don't think, this year at all. Certainly not in my memory. And you know, that's obviously a long time, right? We're now in whatever third, almost fourth month of the year. So that's like 3 or 4 months, even maybe a little bit more since they played each other last year. And I mean, overall, just when you kind of look at it, I think Cloud9 has had a bit of a better run against OpTic than OpTic has had against them, but it's still reasonably even.
It is. And the first map, I think, going into train is going to favor OpTic, I think, as well, just based on it's a map that they're good at, it's a map they've played well on against a bunch of teams, including SK. But, of course, this is OpTic using a stand-in as well. They have Jason R standing in for them as they're still trying to find the new fifth. They've gone through Hiko, then Freakazoid for a couple games, and now they've got Jason R in. And I believe Jason R is also going to be standing in as their RGL.
Yeah, that's what I hear as well. So that's kind of weird, right? You know, you have a guy coming into your team and then all of a sudden he's your IGL, which is like, I mean, how does that really work? You know, how are they going to make that work? I suppose that's something that we're going to have a look at tonight and see whether or not it is working for OpTic. And, well, speaking of OpTic, speaking of Cloud9 as well, maybe some of your favorite fans are going to, or maybe your favorite players are actually going to be here playing tonight. You can go ahead and vote for them in the fan vote if you head over to proleague.com/fanvote. Give him a bit of a props, I suppose, for being good players. I don't know. Who's your favorite player? Not necessarily from tonight, but from Pro League in general.
Oh, man. Favorite player. I'm going to have to go with Jason R. Getting a cheeky Jason R in there.
Okay.
Dog man. I'm a fan of the stream, you know.
Right.
Does good things. I'm hoping he can step up and play well.
We'll see.
But, you know, I also like the Cloud9 boys.
Yeah, look, I mean, I'm more of a big fan of JKS. I think he's a fantastic player, but maybe that's a bit of the Australian bias,
cheeky bias
showing through. I don't know. Speaking of the Australian bias showing through, let's hope that Renegades can make it through to the finals. Maybe not at the way that nine. These two teams are going to be gunning for that because they're up towards the top of the standings at the moment. If they get a 2-0 tonight, or even if they get a 1-1 tonight, it's just going to, again, sort of secure themselves a little bit further towards the top of those standings and really put them in a good position heading into finals.
And looking at the finals as well, Cloud9 are going to be going into this as defending champs, which is a big thing for them to try and do. Of course, they'd love to get a second clean final going ahead. They did get it last season. They managed to get the best of three, I think it was, over SK. So a tightly fought series, but one they managed to come away with. However, repeating that feat would be a massive thing for them, a massive thing for North America, and of course, for Cloud9 and all their fans.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of work to be done if that is going to be the case here. But speaking of tonight, Nuke and Train, the map's coming out here. Obviously, we've sort of spoken a little bit about Train, where we think maybe it might slightly favor OpTic, although in saying that, it's not a terrible map for Cloud9. Nuke coming out, that one's a bit of a sort of a curveball, I thought.
I'd have to agree there. I mean, Cloud9 have played it once in Pro League against Complexity. I believe it was 1915. So against Complexity, who would generally be one of those teams who isn't as dominant in gunning for those top positions in the league, to have to go to overtime against them on Nuke means, sure, Cloud9 can play it, but it's maybe not a map they're exceptionally fantastic at. But OpTic, they might have played it outside of Pro League, but they haven't played it here yet. So this is a pretty new thing for both these teams.
Yeah, I mean, speaking of outside of Pro League, for Cloud9, they have actually played Nuke a little bit, and they've had fairly decent success on it throughout this year. But I wouldn't say it is looking like one of their greatest maps. On the other hand, OpTic, again, they've played it a little bit, but not so much recently. And it has had decent results, but nothing too crazy out there, like amazing 61s or anything like that. So for me, that's a map which is sort of a bit of a toss-up here. Maybe whoever starts on the CT side comes in with a big advantage, can maybe pull away with the first map there. But Train, we know in the past that it's been a strong map for OpTic. We know that they've just defeated SK on it. 16-14, admittedly a very, very close scoreline. But SK, such a strong team, you know, you can't be undervaluing the achievement there that OpTic have gotten on Train. And so for Cloud9 to have seen that just before, and to come up against OpTic now on Train, is that maybe going to be like a bit of a nervous feeling for them, do you think?
It could be, but the other thing is the Cloud9 are also a very good team on Train. They've had some good results on it. They've played it well. It's a map that both these teams like. So them, both of them being able to play on it means this should be a map they're both pretty happy about.
All right, well, having a look at how our team lineup, so we're going to be looking, I believe it's actually not going to be Hiko playing for OpTic. I believe it's going to be Jason R there, but we'll talk about the rest of the OpTic guys. Looking very, very good. Tarek and Mixwell, for me, were the ones that stood up on Train against SK earlier on tonight. I was just watching that one a little bit, and it did seem to be going well for them there. Cloud9, of course, their normal roster back in action with Skadoodle rejoining the team, and he's definitely a key part of that roster. You can see that, 1.46 KD. Best in the server at this point.
Yeah, not quite up there with the ADR as well. It's going to be automatic looking like he's topping out things, 98.3, which is pretty insane average damage. That's just shy of a kill around. And that sort of consistency is just ridiculous to have on your team. If you have one guy that can go out and say, all right, there's five players on their team, I'm going to go out there every single round and make it four. That's a big thing to have in your favor.
Yeah, absolutely massive. And I mean, even if he's not getting necessarily a kill around, he's almost getting it. 98.3. It's basically as good as you could hope for, really. And you sort of want to be sitting, I guess, between like 75 or 70 to maybe about 80 to 90. And that's good. So to be up at 98, that's really, really good. And even Stewie 2K, 85, Nothing 82, they're both really, really good numbers as well. Not quite as impressive there for OpTic Gaming, but it's still very, very good numbers. 80s across the board. Hiko down on 75, but I think he's out of the roster here. So not really a factor there for OpTic Gaming. I got to say, Jason, I mean, when I was watching that one on train, he didn't seem to be setting the world on fire. It was nothing too amazing. He was just in there being solid and plugging away nicely for OpTic Gaming.
Well, considering he's coming in as their in-game leader, that's what he has to do.
Yeah.
As long as the strats that he can put out are good enough for their team to be able to succeed, all he has to put up are decent, consistent fragging numbers. He doesn't have the top frag every single round, of course. Knowing Jason I as a player, I'd be looking for him to step up in pistol rounds. Maybe he can go alive, come alive in clutch situations. He's a very, very good player in that sort of situation. But he doesn't have to do that. He just has to sit there, put out consistent numbers, play well for his team, and provide good strategy.
Yeah, alrighty. Well, we've just had a bit of a pre-show there, but we're going to go for a quick break here while all the players are joining the server. Obviously, give the guys from OpTic a little bit of time to sort of calm down and have a bit of a break between last match and this match. So we'll take a couple of minutes, but we'll be back when the game is ready.
Get your team apparel now at shop.eslgaming.com.
Hey future pros, we have a flash for you that should aid in pushing through the monster tunnel on overpass. This flash should leave your teammates unaffected while the CTs should be blind as heck. To do this flash, line yourself up over the tip of this bottle. Aim over the wall slightly and to the right and then throw the flash. That's it! This should make the Rush B Don't Stop strat work way more in your favor.
Start your esports career now at play.eslgaming.com.
Thank you. I can't understand people watching somebody play a computer game.
It's still not a sport.
It shouldn't be on a sports network.
But I don't know if athlete is the right word.
You like Nuke? No? Where's a common warehouse smoke for you anyway? The lineups for this are nice and easy. It's fairly common AWPers should and this smoke should push them away and force them to relocate. Position yourself over this corner and aim slightly above the metal fixture and then tosh the smoke. Easy, now you removed one of the 45 different angles that CTs can kill you from.
To be part of the Pro League because it's sort of the premier league for all the North American pro teams, and also it gives you the opportunity to make the LAN finals and play against some of EU's best as well.
You know, with the sponsor Mountain Dew, can be really good for up and coming players. It feels amazing to have this opportunity, and I'd never take it for granted, that's for sure.
Start your esports career now at play.eslgaming.com.
Counter-Strike is sharing incredible moments with us and will return to a memorable place. Get your tickets now at proleague.com/Dallas.
We'll be right back.
ESL Pro League is brought to you in part by Logitech G, Pay Safeguard, Mountain Dew League, and ESEA.
Hello, welcome back to the ESL Pro League. Thanks for waiting. It's match day number 16. We're about to get underway with OpTic and Cloud9. I'm told that the server has gone live, which means we'll be into it very, very shortly. But just before that, how do you think this is going? It's a 1-1?
I think it's a 1-1, yes. I'm going to say Cloud9 take Nuke and OpTic take Train.
All right, well, I'm going to be holding off on my prediction depending on which side starts on CT.
You OpTic. Ask me for a prediction and then you're like, oh, but man, I'm not giving mine.
I have the power to throw you under the bus. You don't have the power to throw me under the bus.
I can try. Bad luck.
But, yeah, look, I think definitely I'm backing OpTic to take Train. Nuke, I'm a little bit undecided on. I think that's a bit wishy-washy, but it depends on which side starts on CT for me. So we'll have to find that out when we get into the server.
Yeah, it'll depend. It's an interesting map, Nuke, given that it's so new. These teams, no one's really that sure how to play it, which is interesting. A lot of teams have an idea. It is starting to become more standard in the meta, but it's still very much can be just an off pick for a lot of teams. They just think, we'll try and take this because we don't think our opponents will be ready for it. So, like you said, I think it's going to depend on that CT side start. Whoever gets that, if they can get themselves up towards double digits, get that start rolling. Basically, the thing with Nuke is the less you have to do on your T side, the better off you are.
Yeah, definitely. And pistol round so important as well, particularly for those Ts. If they can get the pistol round, that's really obviously very, very helpful for them. But we're going to find out who will be starting on the CT side here and who's actually going to be winning the first map. So here it is, Nuke and OpTic starting on the CT side. So I think they're in a pretty good spot here, but we'll have to hold off and see whether or not Cloud9 has something for us in their back pockets. Coming in fresh, OpTic coming off the back of a two-match series against SK. So maybe there's something to be said for that, but we'll find out whether or not OpTic are going to be able to continue to play on to their maximum capacity throughout this match.
For now, Cloud9 just setting up on this T side. Starting off nice and slowly here, waiting for someone from OpTic to push them. I don't want to be caught out too early on if they can avoid it here. Cloud9, they want to get this side push underway with all five of their players alive, preferably getting a clean pick or two to get themselves started. But do have a few grenades, which I've just used most of, towards the outside. It's actually Skadoodle playing the utility role this time. Had a flash and a smoke thrown out there, I think. And they're already actually moving to the outside as well. Automatic wrapping in early through the hot spots. Now Tarek going for the fight here as the rest of Cloud9 wraps in through the hut. And they've already started losing players. Jason R's found himself two in this pistol round to start us off. Automatic moving in, looking for the jewels with everyone in the server and can't find anything. Jason R on the site looking to do more damage here. Skadoodle does find one, but Mixwell trades him out. And Jason R still close, preventing this bomb plant from going down. And now it's only Shroud left all on his own. Does have the bomb.
They have not prevented the bomb plant from going down at all. As you can see, Shroud down on the B site. Has got the bomb down. It's 1v3, so difficult task for him, but he might have just heard Jason R coming down through the vent, and they've completely walked past him. What can Shroud do from this position? He can get so much information, but he needs to hit the shots, and hasn't quite managed to do that. Mixwell has spotted him out, and wow, that's unfortunate for Shroud. Good start, though, for OpTic, and you could have thought, well, that might have gone all wrong for them had Shroud maybe hit one or two shots. If he had been in there half a second earlier, they had maybe all lined up for him, but wasn't the case. And have a look at that. Mixwell straight out the bat with an AWP in round number two.
Why not?
No funny business going on here.
Get a knife kill, might as well go for it. If Shroud could have hit that first headshot just the moment he peeked out, if it could have been a nice one-tap on Mixwell, he could have fallen back into vents, maybe moved over to decontamination, tried to play that one out a little bit. But as it was, he was stuck taking that first engagement. And Mixwell got the knife kill and managed to get this with it. So the AWP holding towards outers, this is not something Cloud9 might expect it. Usually a knife kill on the pistol is just used to give more money later in the game rather than immediately investing, but it's only pistols for Cloud9, so I severely doubt they'll be punishing Mixwell.
Yeah, definitely. OpTic would have known Cloud9 got the bomb down, so they can reasonably assume that Cloud9 is not going to be forcing into this round because they want the AKs next round. But yeah, even then, the AWP in this round, that's not worked out too nicely actually for OpTic. And so AWP's dropped. It should be relatively easily retrievable by OpTic, but they do need to actually win this round. And Cloud9 have got good map positioning now. They've got the first pick. Tarek, though, trading it back, taking down Automatic. He's going to be pressured, though, from all sides and answering it quite well as he finds three. Nice eco frags for him. Just getting that aim on point again after maybe the little bit of a break that they had between the SK match and this one. So overall, things have gone fairly well as planned for OpTic. Obviously, they're going to want to upgrade that, or go and pick up the AWP, potentially upgrade the, I'd say, UMP into the AWP. Not sure where Jason R is at the moment, but he'd be the best pick to go and retrieve the AWP at this point. Are they even going to retrieve the AWP?
I don't think they can.
What?
Which, oh, yes, no, there we go. But they, yeah, they dropped off from us for it. Okay.
I was going to say, that'd be a bit silly if they weren't.
Because retrieving that orb had to be priority number one.
Yeah, yeah.
If you're going to invest in orb for knife kill, the number one thing you have to do before you even go for the retake is get that orb. And they just leave someone, I'm guessing they just had someone in a position where they could rotate if they needed, but could also grab that orb, and they will get that thing back. Shroud, though, coming out with the SG, the classic COD gun maneuver, going for that scope, playing the outers. It can work. If he runs into Mixwell, maybe not, but he's got an advantage over the M4s here, potentially.
Potentially. And he's going to have a bit of a peek in, but at this point, not spotting out all that much. No one having too much of a present over on outers, apart from Mixwell picking up from Catwalk. And he's actually taken down again, so that AWP not working too well on the outers area so far for OpTic, though they do get a couple of kills in response. Mixwell and Rush finding one apiece, and OpTic have answered well to the call that Cloud9 have given them. For the moment, Cloud9, I mean, they've got some decent map control over outers now, but what are they going to be able to do with it? Because they're a player down, and they don't have any control over either the bomb sites, so they need to get in there. That's the key at the moment for them.
Still got a lot of time to play with, but if they're going to lose players here to NAF, it's not going to be the greatest of starts for them. NAF does get one before getting traded out. Skadoodle going to get the headshot on Tarek, so it's back into a 2-on-2 here. AK and two AKs for Cloud9 versus the M4 and the UMP of OpTic, but the OpTic players both have the HP in their advantage. There's a kit on Jason R as well, so they've got a little bit of extra time to play with in this retake, depending on where Cloud9 decide to go. And for now, it looks like they are going to be moving over, getting down secret, moving in towards that lower bomb site. With 35 seconds left, they do have time to do this. The question really is how long it's going to take OpTic to be able to figure it out.
Well, Cloud9 have done a pretty good job of actually getting back into this round now. But they're going to have to deal with Jason R, who, by the looks of things, is holding from the ramp room. He's spotting in, hasn't seen anything, but he'll hear that glass shattering. That's going to give away. Cloud9 are headed to the B bomb site. There's no time left for Cloud9 to play with. They have to make this work, and if the bomb does get dropped, that's essentially going to be round over. At this point, though, it looks like Skadoodle has managed to plant the bomb in the smoke. So he's lost a little bit of HP in doing so, but overall, at least getting that bomb down. And now Stewie's in a really, really good spot. He hasn't made any noise. They're not going to know that he's there. Jason R does go down. He gets Skadoodle, but this is looking really, really good for Stewie.
He's got a nice position here to play with, but Rush taps the bomb. If he'd held that, he could have had it because Stewie's not going to peek him and Rush.
Kit.
That's true, actually. He hasn't picked up the kit from Jason. Spots out the shoulder of Stewie, though, or the elbow, I should say, and gets that kill. So full 10-second defuse should be coming on through.
Mm-hmm.
Full investment from Cloud9 there, and they can't make it work. They get close. They get 4 out of the 5 kills. The AWP is dropped and is irretrievable as well. So that's something for Cloud9. They know the AWP is now gone, but there might be enough economy. Yeah, they've got plenty enough money. Jason R can buy one and drop one over. So the AWP is only a temporary removal from the OpTic.
The good thing, at least for Cloud9 here, is that they've got enough money to buy into pistol armor, so they can continue to force that economy down for OpTic Gaming. If they can take maybe 2 or 3 guns out of the hands of the CTs here, they've already started to put some pressure on OpTic Gaming, economically speaking. And when they do eventually get around, you'd have to think that OpTic may be in a difficult position in terms of the buy. So it's not been terrible for Cloud9, even though they're down 3-0. They're still looking like they're in this one at the moment.
Mixwell's having a bit of a rough start at this one today. He hasn't really hit a shot yet. He's just been traded out the last few rounds he's played towards Heaven. Mm. This time, he's missed again, has fallen back though, so for now unpunished, apart from that little bit of health that he has lost, tagged down to 73. But he needs to start hitting his shots here. It's going to be a crucial thing for OpTic. If they can't have Mixwell firing up, then they have really very little long-range presence on the map. Mixwell here. Looks like he's about to get challenged by nothing. He's going to miss that one too. You've got to start hitting these Mixwell. You're going to be a big problem. OpTic going to try to adapt, and he hasn't spotted the player above him, and he will fall to the pistol of Shroud again. Mixwell just not able to get it done. Shroud finds a second one dig there. Rush trades him out. But a 3-on-3 here. Cloud9, regardless of everything else, they've done some damage.
Yeah, again, even if they don't win this round, which you'd have to expect, even at this point, OpTic Gaming are slightly favored given they've got the rifles. Again, as you said, Cloud9 up taking guns out of the hands of OpTic, forcing them to rebuy, and they wouldn't have expected to win this round. They come into this round thinking, okay, let's try and get 3 or 4 guns out of OpTic Gaming's hand. Let's try and get the bomb down. Let's try and make the economy work in our favor, because we're on the T side. It's going to make our life a lot easier, being on the T side a little bit cheaper. So OpTic really need to be doing a little bit better, I think, in these anti-ecos and a lot of these gun rounds that they're giving up a lot of guns in. So Cloud9, for me, even though they're going to be down 4-0, one would think, they're still looking very, very good here. And I think at this point, probably for OpTic Gaming, I would just say to Mixwell, look, I mean, the AWP's not working, or he maybe is going to have to say that himself. Like, guys, I'm not getting the AWP working too well. Let's just try and go full rifle setup and see how that works. But I guess it's something that we're going to have to find out next round, because they're going to have to clutch out this round. Automatic now finding himself in a 1v1. No HP to work with, but almost gets the kill under rush there. It was so, so close, but still a very, very successful round for Cloud9. Pistols and armor only, and not even full armor on all of them. And they get four guns out of the hands of OpTic. They get the bomb down. Cloud9 should be able to buy into this round. OpTic Gaming will be able to buy, but look at the economy. They're not. It's not even really good enough for a proper buy. I'd be surprised if they take the AWP through here, because they'll basically lose a bunch of utility if they do go for that. So I actually like this for Cloud9 still. I'm feeling as though Cloud9 is in the advantageous position right now, even though they're down 4-0.
I'd agree with you there. Cloud9, they're doing all the work at the moment. OpTic are just sitting back and scrambling to adapt. Shroud once again has the Krieg out, challenging at outers once again. Do have an AWP on Skadoodle as well, so he's going to be going for the first pick. But Shroud scoped in, playing the long range angles. OpTic could be caught out by this. They don't have an AWP of their own. They've had it on Mixwell a couple rounds, and he's had no impact with it. I'm not even sure he's hit a leg or anything. He might have, but I don't think so. So it's going to be all in the rifle setup once again. Jason R on the UMP like he has been, getting some money, being the bank for his team, dropping guns for the rest of the OpTic side. Shroud's going to have to check this corner. Mixwell is hiding in it. Going to have to be careful if Mixwell decides to peek this, as Shroud's looking straight past him, and Mixwell going to find an easy kill and two. That's much better.
That's much better from him, but with the rifle as opposed to the AWP. So things working a little bit nicer, and this is such a key round actually for OpTic Gaming, because if they did lose this one, their economy's reset, they can't buy next round, and that's when Cloud9 starts to come back into this. But if they can win this, if they can keep these three guns alive, they themselves will start to build up that economy on the CT side, and then it becomes a problem really for Cloud9. So hanging in the balance right now, but Cloud9 in trouble in this round, and at a certain point, yeah, okay, Cloud9 have been getting good rounds, they've been doing decent damage, but they haven't actually won any rounds, and now is kind of the point where you think, okay, well, they need to start winning some rounds, right? 5-0 down, that's time to start making an entrance for Cloud9. But at the moment, OpTic Gaming have gotten all of them. Again, another buy coming out from Cloud9, but at least OpTic Gaming, again, are going to be able to buy into this round. It'll probably be a bit of a better buy than what they had last round, given that they've got the full rifle set up. They've got a bit more utility by the looks of things as well. And OpTic just need to close this round out again, force Cloud9 back on the eco, and not lose too many guns, and then they're going to be sitting in a really sweet spot. But this is a change of pace from Cloud9 right down to the A-bomb site. They catch off one or two, but they do themselves lose a couple of players. So Cloud9, even though they have control of the A site, it's not around foregone conclusion in their favor. Still though, it's looking okay. They should get the bomb down here safely.
And even if OpTic win this, they've been losing so many guns that their economy is just so severely limited. The most they had in this round was $1,000 or so. That's a beautiful shot from Shroud starting to wake up here. And now Naf coming in from heaven. Needs to try and clutch this one out. Not going to be able to stop the bomb going down. He might just find the angle on Skadoodle, but he's been spotted out by Shroud, and Shroud's going to close it. Yep. Cloud9, after five rounds, will take their first round, and
reset the
there's nothing on OpTic.
Yeah, exactly.
They've been losing so many players to all of these Cloud9 ecos or pistol rounds that they can't buy in this one. They're straight on the pistols.
You think, oh, well, we're 5-0 up, we're going to have a good economy, but no. Not the case here for OpTic, and they're going to actually force into this. So they really know that Cloud9 at the moment are not hugely impressive in terms of the cash department. Obviously, this round they've got a good buy, but the remaining funds in their bank is not looking that amazing. So I think OpTic here are going to try and continue to put pressure on Cloud9. If they can win this round, bring it back to 6-1. Again, that's going to force Cloud9 back onto what would be probably an eco or a force buy. But do you feel as though that's going to be the case? I mean, Cloud9 with full buy, they've already lost the first player, but it's not a great sort of a setup really for OpTic Gaming at this point.
Cloud9 just need to play this anti-eco better than OpTic have played theirs. They need to win this round without losing really any more than one more player. They need three guns up. They need that AWP as well. And Stewie peeking around. Well, they're now out of players. They can lose as Naf almost finds a second on Shroud, but Shroud will get that kill on just 23 HP. Be falling back as well. There's a UMP on Mixwell now too. There's two of those things up for OpTic Gaming, so they can try and do some damage with those. And for Jason R, he's basically on a full gun round again. He's been using a UMP for all but two rounds in this game, being the pistol and the last full rifle round they had, so he'll be pretty happy, pretty comfortable on that. Cloud9, though, in the 3-on-4, Shroud is tagged low. Skadoodle and nothing going to have to do the majority of the work here.
Definitely, and it's not looking that great for Cloud9 at the moment. They're still not sure where they want to go, potentially looking like the A-bomb site, which is what they cracked open very, very easily last round, but Tarek forced down in the vents, bit of Molotov in his direction. Jason R, though, holding the A-bomb site with ease. And it's all just nothing now. So this looks like it's going to be an anti-eco win. Well, yeah, an eco win really for OpTic Gaming. Force win, I suppose.
An anti-eco loss for Cloud9.
Exactly.
if we were back in 1.6, this is a clutch that 1.6 era nothing would win. He loved Nuke. He could wallbang everything. But in Go, I don't think it's as much his playground, and missing the headshot into a jumping mix well means his position is given up for free, has no time to work with, and is not going to be able to save. Tarek's going to come in, clean up the headshot.
Look at that as well. Three guns upgrade, of even four technically, because the UMP comes through as well. So really, really good round for OpTic. Like, that's so much better than even their gun rounds that we've seen so far today. And basically, they're going to fully invest into this round. They don't really have the economy to buy next round, so they want to make sure that they get through this round without losing too much. But again, they're back in that good position. They're back in the driver's seat. Cloud9 sort of peeked their head up for a moment, but then OpTic Gaming sort of was like playing whack-a-mole and just bashed it straight back down.
But OpTic need to not lose a bunch of players in this round. We've seen their anti-ecos already. They've won them, but they've just lost so many players doing so. They need to not do that here. Their economy needs to stabilize, or they're going to have issues the same again going forward. Every time they lose a round, they're just going to be back on pistols. But Rush going to start things off the right way, earning the first kill. Mixwell, there's a nice little crouch B-hop there to get himself out under the garage door. Does strafe away. Jason R finding kills as well. This is better for OpTic. The pistol's being cleaned up.
Way, way better. And OpTic, they at this point are looking like they might be able to close this round out losing no guns. If they do lose a gun, then maybe they can trade out the UMP for whatever is dropped, or if the UMP's dropped, then all's well. But another thing I think to note here for OpTic Gaming is that Mixwell still, you know, he hasn't been doing much with that AWP, hasn't been too challenged this round because he's had a bit of backup over on Outers, but that's, again, I feel as though at the moment, the best sort of a chance for Cloud9 is that they can go Outers, they can take down Mixwell, maybe with a nicely placed headshot from an AK or something like that, and start to take control of the map that way. But if OpTic Gaming is backing him up nicely, if he does start to get on a bit of a roll, then really there doesn't seem to be a weakness at the moment for OpTic.
All of the money.
Was he with the one? No, it was Mixwell that got the knife in the first round.
Yeah, Mixwell but in the 1-on-3 against Shroud.
Still, two knives already for OpTic in this one.
Dollar bills.
Yeah, you got to be rolling in it at this point.
Yeah, that's the UMP is going to be kept by now. The drop could come in from Rush, but it's been working out for them. In the hands of Jason R, it's done very good work in these full gun rounds. Mm-hmm. It's been decent, so why not keep that thing, rack up a little bit of extra cash, and OpTic, that knife kill shows they've learned from their early mistakes. They don't want to have their economy just in the bin every time they lose. They'd love to be able to buy it if they lose a round. And they could have so easily shot Scoodle there. But going for the knife kill, it's the extra little bit of money. It gives them a little bit more to play with here, and that's what they want.
Alrighty, well, looks like Cloud9 might be setting up for some sort of execute on Outers here, which we haven't really seen from them so much. At least tonight, they have been more so just running dry on Outers. They haven't been using too many utilities, maybe a couple of flashbangs and that kind of thing, but relying on their aim more so. And this time they've got the wall of smokes, they've sent nothing down into secret, so he's kind of on the lurk at the moment for Cloud9. They're going to bust out on towards the A site, but really it comes down to what could nothing do, because we should see at least some trades coming out for Cloud9 on the A site, though that's not the case. OpTic shutting them down, in particular Rush finding a couple. Shroud will get the bomb down, but this is not looking good again for Cloud9 and OpTic. They may be able to close this one out with four guns alive, and they will. So another round, another excellent round from OpTic Gaming, completely shutting out Cloud9. Admittedly, Cloud9 do get the bomb down, but at this point, I don't think OpTic Gaming cares too much about that. Their own economy is going to start really starting to ramp up now. They've gone, last round, I think they had four alive. This round, they've had four alive, and have a look at that. They're going to at least be able to afford another buy if they do lose a round here to Cloud9, but Cloud9 needs some rounds on the board right now. 8-1. Yes, it's the CT side of Nuke for OpTic Gaming, but it's already starting to work so, so well for them.
It is. On the T side of Nuke, you really want to get five rounds,
yeah,
six
five.
Rounds. Six rounds would be ideal, but you're looking at the four or five markers is more realistic. That's what you want to get yourself started, because then you can go and do the same thing on the CT side that the other team did to you. But they've got to get themselves, Cloud9, they've got to get themselves to that point. They've only got one. They need, ideally, three or four more. This round is not going to go their way, or it shouldn't go their way. OpTic, their early anti-ecos were sloppy. Their last one was much better. I assume this one will be similar, or is now going to get heavily pressured, but Rush is there to back him up. The damage comes through from the two AK-47s, and two kills go the way of OpTic. Double smoke there, I think, as well. Actually, no, one of those was a HE, but this round's already looking better for them. So Cloud9, they're going to be down 9-1. They need a few more rounds here. They've got to figure out a way to do it.
Tarek should spot out Shroud here as well, just as the smoke blooms. He gets one, does get traded out by nothing, so a small consolation prize at least for Cloud9, but that gives away the information. They know exactly where these two remaining OpTic players are. Probably spotted the guy dropping into... Oh, the bomb.
The bomb fell.
Rush just spotted out automatic as well. Easy kill for him. Just padding those stats a little bit. Three kills on the eco. Can't complain about that at all. And he's on 15 kills for the first half so far. So 15 out of 10. 1.5 kills around, pretty good.
Especially on that 15 and 2 KD, that's pretty impressive from him. But yeah, the buy will be coming back out for Cloud9 here. They cannot afford an AWP, so Skadoodle will have to do without. And Shroud not going for the SG this time. Just going to be on the AK like the rest of his teammates. He's bought that thing out a few times previously, but had virtually no impact with it. And it's full rifles, with the exception of the AWP on Mixwell. And Mixwell needs to get some kills here. There should be a Cloud9 player jumping up on Silo by the looks of things. They've done it a few times previously. But whether or not he can hit that shot is going to be the difference maker. Taric playing in under Silo, playing a bit of a crossfire position with Rush. Cloud9, going to be careful. I don't just walk into this.
We'll have to be careful about everything at this point, because it seems like everything that OpTic is doing is working. Mixwell, though, with the AWP in his hands again. See if he's going to be challenged. Where is he holding? Oh, he's rotating. I think he's actually... Is he on the A site or is he in B? Hard to say. So hard to say.
Classic minimap on Nuke, but Rush is going to be able to hold off the rush of Cloud9. It's not even that. It's just one player. Automatic gets headshot. It's the end of him. Mixwell playing a close fence position on the other side of the vents, I should say. It's not an easy position to AWP out of.
No, but it's not really a position that you would necessarily expect an AWPer to be
in. No, exactly.
Either.
And it's a good one. You can hit your shots. That's fine. It's okay for that. The only problem with it is there is nowhere to fall back. You're just tucked into your corner. You have to take an even tighter angle and just hope you can hit the shot.
That's where you have to rely on your teammates. And he does have two other players on the A site, so Rush should be able to help him out. Jason R as well has been having a good time. Mixwell, he was just running across the map there, and he does go down. So Skadoodle and nothing, finding a killer piece.
Sure.
But it's not quite enough, really, again, for Cloud9. Two guns come through from OpTic, more than enough at this point. We'll see a pause coming out there as well. I have to only assume that that is going to be attack pause coming out from Cloud9, because they desperately need it right now. 10-1. And where do you go from here for Cloud9? Like, they changed up the pace in that one round and went very, very quickly. I think maybe that might be an option for them. Just go quick into A. See if they can maybe make that work, because they've been playing slow. They've been getting picked off. When they have eventually hit a site, OpTic has been ready for it.
The other thing that they can really exploit is Mixwell. He's just not hitting his shots, really, with the AWP. He's just being caught out rotating. He's being headshot before he can get anything done. He even got Deagle killed a few times when Cloud9 were on the anti-eco. So there's not a lot that he's really been able to accomplish. So if they can figure out where Mixwell's playing, the way it's been going, it's a free kill every time. But the other issue is that Mixwell's been changing up his positions. We've seen him holding towards Garage, both inside Garage and outside there along the wall. He's been inside that last round. He was playing close at the opposite vent.
Yeah.
He's changing up his position. So while there is an opening there that Cloud9 can exploit, if he keeps moving, it's not as much of an issue. But still, for OpTic, they can't complain about too much being up 10-1. But if there's anything that they could change, Mixwell really needs to wake up.
Yeah. I mean, look, at the moment, it's going along fine for OpTic Gaming. So you can give him a pass mark at this point. But yeah, maybe on the T side, they're going to need something to open things up. But that's still a while away here. We've still got four rounds going on. So 10-1 is the scoreline right now. It's Cloud9 trying to salvage something out of this first half. And yeah, they're on the T side, but they want a little bit more than just that single round that they've got right now. But generally speaking, tech pauses do result in maybe one or two rounds following. So let's see what Cloud9 has in the back pocket for us.
At the moment, it's a slow round again. We're talking maybe they should go fast, eh? They're not going to do anything fast this time. Just waiting around, trying to catch out someone from OpTic peeking. And that's the thing, OpTic, they don't really need to play aggressive right now. They can just sit back, hold their crossfires, wait for Cloud9 to push into them. As being up nine rounds, OpTic, and wanting to get more, the impetus has to be on Cloud9. It has to come from them. They have to do something. Mixwell, again, has changed up his angle. This time just watching, going for the wall bank through the catwalk. Heavy utility usage towards the hut. An excellent shot from Jason R. Take down one player. That's automatic down. Shroud will trade out one. Shroud doing work on the entry, gets two, but the trade's starting to come in from OpTic. But it's all going in the favor of Cloud9 out of nowhere. And they'll pull off another round. Big kills. Two for Shroud, I should say. One for Stewie, one for Skadoodle, and one for nothing. Only automatic getting left out of the fun. But that was better from Cloud9. They push in a couple players together, and they just managed to isolate the entries, take the one-on-one, and get the kills.
Yeah, definitely. Jason R, really the only one putting up any defense on the A-bomb side in that round. And he has been a bit of a rock, getting kind of one or two kills every round here for OpTic, and looking pretty good. But Cloud9 very, very easily actually able to get into the A site there. So whatever they said, whatever they decided they wanted to do during that attack pause has worked out. But what they need to do here is follow it up with at least these last two rounds, because they allow this, these remain, or the last three rounds here. Because if they allow the last couple of rounds here to go over to OpTic Gaming, 13-2, you know, their economy gets reset. They probably can't buy next round. Then they get a bit of a buy in the final round. It's obviously going to be going really, really nicely for OpTic. And even at this point, things are pretty good for OpTic. I think want one more just to be feeling really comfortable about the first half, but 10 is probably enough.
Exactly. But they will want to try and capitalize on this if they can. And Cloud9 at this point need pretty much every single round as well as the pistol, if they want to have a chance into this. Well, the pistol in the next half, that is. If they can get themselves 10-5, they can win the pistol, push themselves towards 6, maybe go further on their CT side, start to get that economy established. They'll be in a good spot, but Mixwell's played this spot twice now. He's changing up everything, even when he's not AWPing, his rifling spots are changing up. And Cloud9 just can't figure it out. They do get the trade this time at least, but they're back in a 4-on-4. They've got to try and find something here, and they're pretty split up as well.
The good thing, though, is that they at least have a lot of control over outers, and so they've got a lot of options as to where they want to go. Automatic can peek into uppers here. Rush, oh, I don't think Rush knows. Automatic, you know, that's not the kind of angle that you'd expect a T to be in. And Rush, if he peeks this one at the wrong time, he's going to go down, though he has spotted out Automatic, and that forces Automatic to fall back. It's a bit of a game of cat and mouse at the moment. Who's going to take the actual peek? Who's going to go for the duel? And at the moment, it's going the way of Cloud9. Rush, he only gets one before being traded out by Shroud, and Naf left alone. 1v3. Not sure what the economy's like here for OpTic Gaming. I have to hazard a guess that they can afford a buy in the next round, even if Naf does go down.
Naf's on 1950.
He's going to be saving. Yeah, he's on 1950, but I thought there was a couple of other guys with a bit more money.
There should be. But Cloud9, these rounds are looking better for them. They've been able to push in. They can take the kills. Ooh. I mean, look at the economy. Yeah, there's
not
nothing.
Enough.
This
right.
is just going to be... This rifle is going to have to be the hero rifle in the next round for OpTic Gaming. But Cloud9, I'm liking what they're doing with these slower rounds. They're working in as a group, really. They are doing some splits in, but it's mostly just they walk into the A site... They go in, they isolate the one-on-ones, they take it slow, peek the angles one at a time, make sure everything is clear before moving on, and then they're just hitting their headshots. They're getting the entries through. Shroud got himself a 2K on the entry this round. He's been playing well. That's what they need to do. They need to just be able to walk into these sites and win their duels. But the question is it too little too late?
Maybe. Maybe it is. They're going to have to eco out this round, OpTic, so we won't expect too much from them. Oh, they're forcing into it. Okay. I would have thought they'd eco and go for a full buy next round, but...
The buy's not bad.
The buy's not bad, but it's not excellent. And if they do lose this one, the next buy that they're going to have is not going to be great either. So they're kind of banking on either get two rounds or they get no rounds.
Pretty much. That's basically the goal here for OpTic. And to be fair, no matter what happens, they're in a good spot. They're guaranteed at minimum 10 rounds in their CT side. That's par for the course, I would say, for CT on Nuke. You'd love more, but you also would be... a bit unhappy with less. So 10, they're going to be all right with that. Of course, they would love to push this to 12 if they can, but they've still done enough to get themselves a good start on their T side. For Cloud9, they still got a lot of work to do. They need these last two rounds plus the pistol so they can start building back into this game, because right now, even though they have the better buy here, they're still a long way behind.
Yeah, definitely. OpTic Gaming, though, if they can close this out 12-3, I mean, that would just be basically curtains for Cloud9. Barring some sort of heroics in the second half, they'd absolutely need to win the pistol round at this point. Maybe they don't necessarily need to win the pistol round. They'd like to, but getting a bit ahead of ourselves at this point, because Cloud9 are starting to barrel into the B site. They've actually gone down the ramp room, which is, I think, probably the first time that they've really put any sort of committed push in there. They did kind of explore it earlier on, but OpTic Gaming was able to hold them out of that area. This time, though, Cloud9 have got control of that, and all is up to Naf as they make their way onto the B site.
He's playing a bit of an interesting angle as well here at the bottom of the ramp, just looking for the headshot. Really wants someone to peek into him right now. We'll have teammates on the way, but Cloud9, they've given up on this. Jason R, though, does find a kill, and Skadoodle's got a player dropping on him. It's Mixwell with the UMP who finds the headshot, and now it's a 3-on-2. Shroud and Stewie have to try and do something here. They have managed to move back up to the A site and get the bomb down, where they lost a lot of teammates in the doing so. Now they've got to try and hold off all three OpTic players coming in. Mixwell from the vents gives himself away with that HE coming up, but Tarek's coming in behind through the heart. I think actually all their players are coming from there, so they've got a crossfire here, Stewie and Shroud, but they've got to make it work.
Yeah, and there's not a lot of time to work with here for OpTic, and that's a great couple of shots coming out from both those C9 players. Now 1v1 for Shroud and Naf. The grenade right at the feet of Naf, picking him up. Shroud clutching it out 1v1, but really, really nice 2v3 from Cloud9, and that's basically confirming almost that Cloud9 is going to be able to take this through to 5 on the T side, which would be a very, very good scoreline even considering the point that they were at. But maybe OpTic Gaming has something up their sleeve. They did win one sort of force buy already this half. Maybe they can do it again. And 11 would be definitely much better than 10.
Three UMPs and 2 5.7s to make it work with, though. Cloud9, they've got themselves the full rifles. This should be an okay round for them if they take it. If they play it slowly like they have been and win their entries, and just as a quick note as well, Shroud clutching on Nuke, that gives me some good nostalgia from older days before I even joined Cloud9. I don't know if you've seen that clip, but he wins a a 1-on-5 on the A side, starting with a 5-7, I believe, upgrading to a rifle and just kills everyone.
I've
but,
probably seen the clip. I mean, I've seen a lot of clips. It's hard to remember them
Such as life as a caster. Many clips. But Cloud9, back in the present day, it's good to see that Shroud still has it in him. He's been doing well, actually, getting the entries onto the A side. But they're going to have to find some more heroes. There's three UMPs looking to do the damage, and all of them playing quite close angles as well. And this time, Shroud not going on the entry, waiting in behind to wait for this push from the ramp. Nothing in the meantime. Going to take the first pick onto Mixwell. Starting things off the right way for his team.
Yeah, it just seems as though OpTic is a little bit sort of eager to push in this round, and it's working out for them actually, because they're taking control of lobby. Naf and Jason are finding a kill apiece, and now they're gonna have to try and probably retake the A bomb site because Shroud seems to be coming in from outers. Where's he gone? Oh, there he is.
He threw a Molotov on himself, so he had to run out.
Okay, that was a little bit interesting. But player advantage at the moment for OpTic. They've retrieved some guns as well. Three UMPs and an AK. Definitely workable with 30 seconds left here for Cloud9 in the first half. They need to take it through to 5, I think. 11's not going to be too easy of a task to chase down.
Jason R with the UMP, though.
He's been a rock. He has absolutely been a rock on the A-bomb site, especially considering, as you said, he's with that UMP. More often than not, he's just been taking away the less than ideal weaponry. Shroud, though, doing a good job pushing. And it's now again 1v1, and again it's going to be Shroud to win it out. So Cloud9, they do manage to get 5 rounds in the first half. We have to find out whether it's going to be enough, though, in the second half, because 10, it's a good sort of a scoreline for OpTic. It's not amazing and probably not where they would have wanted to have been at the end of this half.
Yeah, well, that's unfortunate. But either way, Cloud9, they brought something back. It was a 10-1 at one point, and they managed to bring it back in. It's better than it could have been. Mm. It's still not great, but it's better than it could have been. Shroud there getting a couple clutches at the end. I think they were both
1v1s.
Yeah, 1v1s eventually. So, manages to get a couple clutches across the line. That's going to be good for Cloud9 if he can keep doing that. But now moving over onto the CT side, this is where they have to do the bulk of the work. They need to have an 11-4 half if they want to take this game out. And just 10 rounds, even to secure overtime, they need 10 rounds, which is a lot. But on the CT side, we just saw OpTic do it, so Cloud9 will be looking to step up and do the same thing.
Yeah, definitely. It's entirely possible. They want to start off with the pistol round. I think that's obvious to say. But if they don't, then OpTic, you'd think, probably get to 13, maybe depending whether or not the bomb goes down, something like that, maybe only 12. But it's obviously really a tough situation right now for Cloud9 because they need to start off so well and they need to continue so well. That's why it's so much easier to start on the CT side because you kind of have a bit of an easier time in the second half. You know how many rounds you need to get. But on the T side, when you start on the T side, like, you know that you're maybe not your more difficult half, because generally the T side is going to be more difficult, but the one where the pressure is going to be on you is going to be that second half.
The driving force has to come from the T side.
The driving force has to come from the CT side. So exactly.
Which, yeah, it's difficult starting off on the T because you need to get so many more rounds. Because as you said, on the CT side, if you can win 9, 10, 11 rounds, you think, great, we need four, however many rounds. You know exactly what you're aiming for. Whereas on the T side, it's a lot more open-ended. It's just, we need to try and win as many rounds as we can. And that's not an easy thing to do, especially when you're playing against a team who is proficient on the CT side of Nuke, as indeed we've seen OpTic are, with the one exception being Mixwell, not having the greatest of days, but I think he might have had an operation potentially on some painkillers or something like that. But either way, he's not having the greatest of starts, but it doesn't matter as the rest of his team are firing on all cylinders. And Jason R, worth noting him as well, has been playing. Yep. He's been playing really well. He is only a stand-in for OpTic. I wouldn't be surprised if he keeps playing like this to see him become their new permanent fifth.
Well, potentially, but at the moment, we'll have to find out whether or not that's going to be the case. I think the Rush is the other one to mention for OpTic Gaming. He was playing very, very well, at least at the start of that first half. Kind of cooled down towards the end, but we'll see whether or not he's going to be able to fire up again here. And at the moment, it's 2v3 for OpTic. 1v3 now, as Naf finds himself alone. And this is not the situation they would have wanted to find themselves in. They would have wanted to get that pistol round and really start to put some pressure on Cloud9 early on in the second half, but it's a bit more breathing room now for C9. OpTic didn't get the bomb down, though. Do they force into it? Looks like they will. Tarek's gone for it, at least.
But only pistols. So the buy not going to be great for them. Cloud9 now, they need to stabilize. They need to play this anti-eco cleanly. That's the thing. This is the problem that OpTic had early on, in that they could beat Cloud9 in the anti-ecos, and they did. But they lost a lot of guns doing so. So the moment they lost one round, 5 rounds in, I believe it was, they were just straight back onto the eco. Cloud9, they want to do better than that. They need to win these anti-ecos, and they need to win them with 3 or so players alive. They don't need to, well, they don't want to be losing a lot of guns going forward, because they're behind. And OpTic managed to get 10 rounds on the board, given that their economy was just in the bin to start off with. But Stewie going to find himself the first kill towards ramp, get himself a little bit of bonus money for the UMP, falls right back, throws a Molotov to cover himself off. Cloud9 taking no chances in this round.
Taric, though, has found one onto Skadoodle, but he'll be traded out straight away by nothing. And overall, it does look like it should be fairly easily cleaned up by Cloud9, though. Mixwell jumping headshot onto nothing. That's nice from him. And he'll be able to take a FAMAS here. Is he going to save it?
In a 2-on-3, he could potentially try and use it, but Nav's going to need to find something as well. Whether that's a kill, whether that's a gun, he's got to figure out something to do. He's on his own with the bomb as well. Mixwell looks like he wants to move in for the flank.
Mm.
But he's got to move over and find Nav as well. As Nav, firing those few deagle shots, has given away where he is.
Yeah, maybe just trying to draw a rotation from C9 that may get cut off by Mixwell or something like that. But right now, OpTic, the ones that are going to have to rotate themselves, and they do not have any time or much time to play with at all. Stewie spotting out Mixwell, does a bit of damage. Low automatic doesn't seem to be ready for that. There will be a trade out straight away from Shroud. That gives away his position. And now Naf knows where he is. If he had hit that shot, then there was game on. But right now, the timer just ticking away. He has to move so quickly and going to go right down into the B site and lands on top of Stewie. Not what he would have wanted. So overall, a good round for Cloud9. At least they take a couple of guns through. But OpTic, yeah, would have hoped for a little bit more, I think, there.
That said, though, Cloud9 still lose three guns. It's three players they have to rebuy on. This is what happened to OpTic on their CT side early on. They won the anti-ecos, but they lost guns. And when you have to rebuy guns, it just dents your economy. So Cloud9, they need some clean rounds here. And Shroud, sticking with the pattern of buying the scoped rifles rather than the standard variations, had a Krieg last half. This time he's going for an AUG. First kill actually goes the way of a Molotov or an incendiary grenade, I should say, despite all that. Another one into the site to drop the bomb. Shroud tapping away, drops Jason R, and Nav's been spotted out. So the bomb does go down. Stewie's already on it. All of OpTic will fall. One gun is dropped. That's on Skadoodle, but doesn't really matter as the big guns will be saved. The M4 and the AUG, which actually got two kills, will stay alive.
All right, well, this is going to be the first buy from OpTic Gaming. They got the bomb down in the last round, so they are going to be able to pretty much fully invest into this one with the exception of the utilities for Mixwell and the head armor for Mixwell. But apart from that, they're looking pretty peachy. Cloud9, they'll be taking some guns through from last round, so a couple of FAMASs. Overall, I would say it's probably a bit of a better buy actually for OpTic, but in reality, it just comes down to who's going to aim better in this one. There's not much between the two sort of setups. And OpTic so far on the T side haven't been able to pick up a round. This is their best chance so far, though. And I think they need it as well, right?
They do. They've got to figure out something here, because if Cloud9 get this one, then this is an early buy. Well, not an early buy, a standard buy, fourth round, but it's a very full buy, full investment from the OpTic guys. So if they lose this one, they're going to be pretty much forcing, or well, it's unfortunate for Rush got to hit that jump, but their economy is going to be really not great. That Northtop
nice
does not go far enough from nothing. It will be extinguished by the smoke. So.
Name Molly?
Yeah, name Molly, sure.
Yeah. Doesn't really matter, though, for OpTic. Like, they weren't even actually pushing through that. So this is, like, kind of a little bit of a fake at this point. They've maybe tried to make Cloud9 think that they've got someone into secret there, but their actual main force is still hanging around out as the Molotov goes in there from OpTic. Just to clear things out, and Taric is going to walk right around, picks up an easy kill onto nothing, looks for a second onto Shroud, but doesn't even manage to really do all that much damage. So 4v4 as the trades come out for Cloud9. As of yet, though, OpTic haven't really made any inroads into either of these bomb sites, and they've only got 35 seconds left to work with, so we are going to have to see a bit of an explosion sooner or later.
OpTic going to have to move quite quickly, given how slowly they've started this one out, only finding one pick early on as well. You need to do more if you're going to play it this slowly, but now the push will be coming in, and Shroud up on top. We'll be looking to get it done with the Org. Finds one, and automatic lines him up with the FAMAS. Finds himself two, upgrades to an AK-47 for free as well. Cloud9 now in the one round behind.
Just a complete shutout there from Cloud9, and they are looking so very good on their CT side as well. Just goes to show what a change of sides can do. Cloud9, they were looking a little bit troubled in the, well, in the early stages of the first half. The second half of the first half, God, that's a mouthful. They actually looked quite decent, you know, getting
second
some rounds
quarter.
On the, yeah, second,
maybe.
Second quarter of the game, I suppose. But yeah, like Cloud9, they looked quite good in that late stages of the first half, when they were on their T side, they got some rounds there. They've given themselves enough to play with here, and right now they are looking at ease on the CT side. They're not really being challenged too much by OpTic. Again, OpTic, though, going to have the economic problems. They will just be buying pistol and armor in this one. So last round, it obviously looked good for Cloud9, but there's still a couple of chances here for OpTic to get some guns in their hands before this game is over, and they need to make use of them. This round, though, it's not too bad. They've got one kill, but overall, you have to expect that Cloud9 should be able to pick up the win here. And I think that at the moment, Cloud9's actually looking a little bit better than what OpTic did on their CT side, because they're being able to take a lot more guns through from their previous rounds. They're being a little bit more convincing in those early CT rounds. And OpTic, they're going to need to answer back shortly, because time is running out.
It is. And Jason R does have full armor into this one, which he brought with him, and he's managed to steal that AK-47 as well. So if there's going to be any damage done by OpTic in this round, it's going to have to start with him. Pre-firing a couple corners to get out onto the lower side as well. Does have the bomb down there with him. So once he clears this out, he can potentially go for this plant, but there is players waiting for him. Stewie waiting in the back corner. Just going to give Jason all the space he needs to go out and plant that bomb. And in a 2-on-4, you don't need to be pressuring for these 1-on-1s. You can just let the bomb go down. Wait until you have a confirmed lock on at least one of these players' locations, then you can go for this fight. And now Rush has fallen. Jason R going to be in the 1-on-4 with 20 seconds left. Needs to plant this bomb very, very soon. Going to find a lot of players to do that. Stewie gives himself away. Shroud coming into the vents. Well, coming out of the vents, I should say. But Skadoodle coming in from ramp will be able to find the angle and the kill. Mm-hmm. Only one kill for OpTic in that round. They would have needed more.
Yeah, very, very similar to the previous round as well. Cloud9 just having such a good time on the CT side right now, but it will be equalized at 10 apiece. OpTic Gaming with the buy again into this round, looking still for their first round in the second half. So searching for a T round here. As of yet, Cloud9 really not giving them anything, not giving them much of a chance. So this is looking a bit dangerous now for OpTic Gaming, right? When you see yourself at 10-10, you think, okay, well, the CT side favored from this point out because they should be getting more rounds. It's going to have to be a big effort, a big step up from OpTic Gaming on this T side. So far on the T side, they haven't shown us anything. Only had one gun round, admittedly.
But even though they only have one, they still need to get something more done here. And they're taking a lot of damage from the Molotovs as well as they run through. They're getting straight down into secret, automatic, being pressured. Drops a grenade to cover himself, goes for the spray, but Mixwell finds the shot, takes that automatic. 5-on-4 already, OpTic. They've done better this time. They haven't lost a player. They managed to get the first kill. And this is how it happened for Cloud9 as well. They went down 5 and then won their first round. So potentially mirror image half here, but Cloud9, they're not done with this one yet. OpTic are wrapping all over this B side, but Stewie's going to find himself the first kill. Only one, though, and Nap on the late flank could potentially stop all of Cloud9, but Shroud with the Org, he's been playing well with that thing. He's going to get himself one more kill into a 3-on-3 with a bomb down.
Jason R in a key position here as well as Shroud. Both those guys, if they can find a kill or two, and Shroud finds one on a mix, well, Skadoodle does take down Jason R, and it's, there you go, round over. Cloud9 are going to be able to pick that one up. Skadoodle's been doing pretty good work on the CT side with that AWP. Definitely had more impact so far than what we saw from Mixwell when he was on the CT side with the AWP. And that's a good early sign for Cloud9. Not only is he getting the shots early on in the round, he's also getting the shots on the retake. So this is really starting to shape up and look very, very nicely for Cloud9.
Look at the money as well. Stewie, before he bought there, had 12k. Shroud, given that he hasn't died in about 1,000 years, still has that org and still has 11k, doesn't need to rebuy.
23 and 11.
Yeah, he's playing very, very well. It's interesting that both of the guns that are really stepping up on the CT side have scopes, and they're not both sniper rifles. Normally it's a double AWP, maybe a DAC-DAC, potentially, if a team's really far ahead, but the org being this effective, Shroud just really feeling the scope weapons today. He had the SG out on the T side, didn't have as much effect with that, but the org, he's having a great time with it. As you said, 23 and 11.
Yeah, but in general, I mean, Cloud9 are having a great time on the CT side. Again, OpTic Gaming is going to be able to invest into this one. The T economy working nicely for them, but it's just not been working out too well for them. Like, they've been able to get into the sites, but they haven't been able to win any of the fights. And Shroud pushing this time. OpTic Gaming not ready for it. So Cloud9 changing up the CT side over and over and giving themselves the most advantageous positions possible to be able to close this map out. And at the moment, it's not even looking like OpTic Gaming is going to win a round on the T side. Maybe that's a little bit premature to say something like that. There's still a lot of rounds here, but Cloud9 have just been really shutting them out.
Oh, Skadoodle. Beautiful shot there. Moves back over. I thought he was going to miss the movement onto Jason R. Misses the shot on Tarik, but that is a very difficult one to hit. Shroud, in the meantime, getting more work done with the org. Loving that. And Stewie, coming from underneath, gets the final kill on
Another
Tarik.
Convincing round for Cloud9. Four guns through. Economy.
Look at that.
Look at that. 14k, 15k almost for Shroud. Over 10k for Stewie. It's, yeah, I mean, they'll get 13 here before OpTic Gaming gets another buy.
And Cloud9 here, they've achieved the dream of CT sides on Nuke.
Yeah.
Their economy is set. That's all they want. They do have a few players who are a little bit lower, but they've also still got some double digits in the money, I believe. So they're not bothered at all by this. Shroud continuing with the org, just doing great damage with it, which is interesting. It's not usually a gun that we see too much of in the pro meta. It's used occasionally. The SG is picked up on the T side a bit. Look at players like Magisk Boy. He takes that a few times over in Europe. But the AUG, we really don't see too much of. But Shroud, he's decided he's going to make it his own here as he's doing a lot of work with it. Skadoodle did find the first kill in this round. Could be caught out by a Deagle here, but falls back with just the right timing and takes up an alternate angle through the window.
Jason R does get one, but he's dropped relatively low right now. 19 HP. Still, I guess you would take that trade. A kill's a kill. An optic. Oh, it would have heard automatic drop there, but he's going to push in. Nope, he's not going to push in. What's he going to do? He spots out Naf. Here's the squeaky door opening. Here's the footsteps. He knows he's being pressured right now by Tarik. And actually, he goes down, but he gets a lot of decent damage out. So that's a good sign for Cloud9 at least.
All the optic players left are just so low.
Yeah.
There's the first kill coming in for Skadoodle. He can really do all of this with the CZ if he needs to, as there's just no HP on these optic guys. There we go. There's another one. Looks like he's listening to me. There you go. The 4K comes out for Skadoodle.
Yeah.
Three of those on the CZ. That's all you need to do, really. He doesn't even need to go for the sniper rifle in that situation. Mm-hmm. He knows they're all so low. His teammates have called the dinks, called the tags. He can just sit there with his pistol and rain hell. And indeed he has.
Shroud again surviving another round. So he's up to 26 and 11. I wonder how high he can go. And I'm going to say it before Cloud9 actually close this one out, because it does look like Cloud9 are going to be able to close this out. It may even be 16-10. Another buy, though, coming out from OpTic, and it's time for them to bash their head against the wall once more and see if they can break through the defense of Cloud9. OpTic starting off, though, with a good kill in that round. Mixwell finally getting something done with the AWP. But is it going to be enough here for OpTic to actually win the round? Because Cloud9, even when they've been at deficits, have still looked relatively good.
They have. They've been playing well, so the double AWP up, actually, on Skadoodle and Stewie. That's still in effect. That's still going to be here. Skadoodle going to find himself one. Getting pressure from a lot of angles. Trying to fall back right now. Taking lots of damage from the AK of Rush there. And Rush now still trying to find this kill. Skadoodle has fallen back. He has a little bit of time to work with here to get himself into a better position. But his days, unless he can get some support, are numbered in this round. Or his minutes, I should say. It's not really days in a round of Counter-Strike. Tarik, in the meantime, going to open up onto automatic. It's all the scopes now for Cloud9. Two AWPs and one AUG to do the work. But that AUG on Shroud has been very, very effective in Skadoodle. He's relocated all the way into heaven, holding the angle on secret. Didn't spot the timing. That's really unfortunate. I thought he would have as well, but the vent blocks, or the vented catwalk, blocks his movement, or blocks his vision, I should say. And now Stewie and Shroud have to try and clutch this 2-on-3 out. They've got a 2-on-3 before in this half, Cloud9, but they're going to need another one here if they want to stay flawless. And the bomb going down in the smoke.
Stewie is just walking around on the B site, and that's really actually very, very good for them, because I think they came in through that door, and they're not going to expect Stewie there. Can he deny the bomb plant? That's huge. That is absolutely huge. All he has to do now is survive.
Tarik, he broke the vents. He has an idea of where he is in the... Ooh, Tarik, we'll get the 180 on just 4 HP and survive. So finally a round for OpTic, but only just. That was so well played by Stewie
so
there.
So well, yeah.
Denied the bomb plant. I mean, of course, Shroud just walking through a smoke, denying the bomb plant the first time. Stewie managing to deny it the second and got so close to getting the kill on Tarik there. But on just 4 HP, Tarik finally puts one on the board for OpTic Gaming. Mm. Only 2 rounds behind now. The buy is going to be there. It's still not great. Shroud, he's finally died, but he's just bought another AUG again because why not? He's got the money. Might as well. He's been playing well with that thing. The double AWP was an experiment from the Cloud9. Will not be repeating in this round. They've still got one, though, on Skadoodle, and this setup has worked very well for them so far this half.
Well, let's see how many rounds OpTic is going to be able to put together here now, because if they do take down Cloud9 in the next round, Cloud9 probably going to be ecoing. They only had one player that was with any sort of cash to speak of, and that was Shroud, about 5k. So maybe they could go for pistol armor or something on the CT side, but definitely OpTic are in with a chance here to be able to equalize the scoreline and start to bring it back. Comes down to this round, though. Very important one, both of those teams.
We're going to be on this first pick, and that's an unfortunate one for Skadoodle to miss, but he will be able to fall back without taking damage, so not the worst thing in the grand scheme of things. Shroud up high. Potentially could have a lot of players coming his way, but Stewie now waiting over towards the ramp. Throws in a Molotov, doesn't want this rush to come his way without at least a little bit of damage already being done, or even a slowdown, potentially a halt care of that Molotov. But he's playing a bit of a headshot angle here. Smoke going to come out as to relocate. Mixwell's holding the angle on him, though. He has to be very, very careful. It's a perfect flashbang. Spots a lot of feet there, I think. Can now fall all the way back into this B site. The push is going to come. The rotate for Cloud9 is not quite here yet. They've got to try and figure out how they can reposition. Nothing. May have heard a lot of footsteps there, but on the whole, Cloud9 haven't really moved.
35 seconds left now, 25 actually on the clock, so OpTic need to get that bomb down relatively quickly. Stewie does take down Rush, but it's Jason R with the bomb, and he should be able to get this one down. Okay, he's getting tagged, but he does manage to plant it. And Tarik and Naf finding one apiece, brings it back to 3v3, as Cloud9 are going to need to try and retake this, though. They've been fairly decent on those retakes so far, particularly the ones where they've had Skadoodle alive. But this time, Skadoodle is dead, no AWP on the field. Shroud, I think, is going to be the one to step up. Automatic, though, does spot one out. Shroud gets another, and there we go. It's round over. OpTic Gaming, their money is going to be reset. I don't know if they can afford to buy next round. I guess they have to, really.
Got to go for something.
What have they got? Oh, not enough. Not enough to buy, really.
So they've got to make a decision here. Do they force now, which is almost like they're doing, or do they play for overtime? Right now, it looks like they're going to have to just take this round as it is. Hopefully get the bomb down.
Saving.
They are. This round, they can maybe get the bomb down. That'd be best case scenario. Get a little bit of extra money, but that's all they're going to get at this point. They've got one set of armor on Mixwell. He's got himself a Tech 9 as well. Just pistols for the rest of them. Jason R not buying anything. They are moving very, very quickly down the vents, but these Molotovs doing so much damage. Perfect Molotov placement. One inside the hut, one out the window. There is nowhere to go. The kill's already coming through. The bomb, the bomb's gone.
It's dead and gone. Cloud9.
Speaking of dead and gone.
Really good round for them. 15 on the board now. OpTic will at least be able to afford to buy into this one, but they have to try and take it to overtime now. And so far, only one round on their T side.
Cloud9 have won 10. I mean, it's exactly a mirror of the first half. We have 10 and 1 for OpTic in the first half. Now we have 10 and 1 for Cloud9. But because Cloud9 got enough done on their T side that when they came in here and showed this dominance on CT, it was enough, more than enough. They've got 4 match points to play with right now. They just need to not overextend here. If they move too quickly, they can potentially give away this round. They just need to not be rash. Just relax. They've got the rounds to play with and just take this one out.
Yeah, no real reason to change things up at the moment for Cloud9. What they're doing is working. Automatic, he spots out one, gets a grenade in there as well. Won't do any damage with that, but favorable trade overall, at least for Cloud9. They get some damage across and they get some information as well. So OpTic playing again quite slowly this time. Obviously in the last round, they were just on the pistols. They decided to go quickly. Clearly didn't work out for them, but they haven't really been too interested in playing super quickly so far on the T side anyway. Just trying to feel things out a little bit. Have to think though, Cloud9 are in a good spot here. Full rifles, plus the AWP, full utility, full defuse kits, everything that they wanted. And the form, the aim is working quite nicely for Cloud9 tonight by the looks of things. Nothing spotting out a couple more players there. And again, OpTic are letting this time a tick down relatively low. That's the bomb dropped by Automatic as well. He'll spot out Mixwell and actually wins that duel too.
360.
And yeah, that was the sort of the 360 no-scope. I guess it's always a no-scope really with the AK. But hey, Automatic, we'll give him credit for that. And Automatic, he's basically single-handedly won this round. 3 kills for him. Rush has been spotted out. There goes Shroud picking it up. So 16 and 11 is going to be the first map score. OpTic, they looked good on the first half, but when they moved over to the T side, Cloud9 started to pull ahead, and well, you kind of have to expect that. CT side of Nuke, proving to be supreme.
And fitting that Shroud closed it with the AUG as well, given that he had such a big impact with that thing. I'm not quite sure if he made it to 30 kills, but he must have been very, very close. And it's great to see him really stepping up and having the impact, because when you talk about Cloud9, or you see people talk about Cloud9, the common theme is always, they're a good team, but Shroud underperforms, and Shroud has been able to find his mark. But today, he found it. On the CT side especially, he's like, all right, guys, the AUG. Today, the AUG is my thing. Going to make it work. And he did.
He did definitely make it work. He was super, super impactful. Everyone, it seemed to me, for Cloud9 was stepping up. I think nothing, you know, he didn't really seem hugely impressive, but he didn't need to be. Skadoodle was doing well. Stewie had his rounds, but he wasn't particularly consistent either. I think it was really Automatic, Shroud, and Skadoodle for me that were doing the majority of the work there for Cloud9. Particularly on the CT side, I thought the AWP was working very well for Skadoodle. The clutches for Stewie, even though he maybe didn't get too many actually successful ones, he got that one, which was very close. He was putting in impactful kills in the rounds where they had to get retakes, and then Shroud was just there doing his thing. So basically, it was all working very, very nicely for Cloud9. They do pick up the victory on Nuke. We'll head over to Train in just a second. We are going to go to a break, though, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back with map number 2 very, very soon.
Start your esports career now at play.eslgaming.com.
Get your team apparel now at shop.eslgaming.com.
Wants another go at it though. Bolts is there, and another land to the slaughter. And Nico, what a round to come alive from this man.
The game has changed. This is why FaZe wanted Nico.
ESL Pro League is brought to you in part by Logitech G, Pay Safeguard, Mountain Dew League, and ESEA.
G'day guys, and welcome back to the ESL Pro League North America Division. It's Season 5, Match Day 16, and it is now our final map of the day between OpTic and Cloud9. Now, Cloud9, they looked pretty good there on Nuke. It started off a little bit slow for them, but once they got on that CT side, it almost seemed like a sure thing that they were going to close that out.
Yeah, once they made it onto the CT side, they could really just roll through. They got the pistol round, they started getting their gun rounds together, they got their economy established. Shroud had $15,000 at one point. He did really good work with the org. It was all the Cloud9 show once they switched sides.
Yeah, definitely. And that's not a good sign for OpTic, but at least they are going to be moving over to Train, which is definitely one of their comfort maps coming into this one. Admittedly, Cloud9, not any slouches at Train either, so I think we're going to have another good matchup coming out here in map number two. But I said at the start of today, I thought it was going to be a 1-1. I thought OpTic was going to pick up Train. Or maybe I didn't say 1-1. I thought it depended on what was going on for the CT side, so maybe I did in the end sort of... In a roundabouts kind of way.
You made me give a prediction.
No, I think in a roundabouts way, I kind of actually predicted a 2-0 to OpTic because I said whoever gets the CT side first on Nuke would win. But anyway, I definitely think OpTic can win Nuke here. Train, not Nuke.
I'd have to agree with you because Cloud9, they've played Nuke well. Train, I'm doing it too. They've played Train well. They're not a bad Train team. They've got wins against, I think it was a 16-5 against Complexity and a 16-9 against Immortals earlier in the season. So Immortals, certainly not a bad team. A good team to have wins against, but... Yeah. OpTic, Train is just one of their go-to maps. It's, as you said, it's a comfort map for them. It's a map where they can get onto it and just be like, all right, guys, we know how this works. We know what we're doing. We'll be fine. So I think OpTic should be able to take this one.
Yeah, the only sort of a blip, really, in the run of games on Train for OpTic is that loss against NRG, which they had earlier on this season, 16-12 on Train. But they took down SK earlier on tonight on Train. They've taken down Selfless. They've also been able to take down a lot of the other teams around the place. Like, you know, it is tending to be one of their go-to maps in general and not just in the Pro League. But we'll have to see how they start off here. I assume that Cloud9 is going to be picking the side because... Nuke, it seemed as though OpTic picked the side, so I assume OpTic starting off on the T side. It's not going to be the easiest of tasks for them, but it's not as bad as starting off on the T side of Nuke.
Yeah, and even that, it didn't end up being as much of a hindrance for Cloud9 as we thought it would be, as they do come away with the win there after really getting going on their CT side. So, still not a done deal by any stretch. We've seen that both teams are, all players are really firing pretty well. Jason R doing well on OpTic as the stand-in in the IGL. Mixwell looking a little bit lost. On the side of Cloud9, it's... Nothing, he really didn't have the greatest of impacts, but it's not that anyone is really completely absent in this. No. It's just we've got a few players firing up and some players who aren't as much, but when you've got a few players who are hitting their shots, for example, looking at Cloud9, we had Skadoodle and Shroud really playing well, Automatic also standing up there, as well as Chewy having some nice rounds. When everyone's playing decently on the team, it doesn't need to be a real standout fragger, but... That said, going into Train, I'm still going to stick with my pick of OpTic taking this one out.
Yeah, OpTic, for them, when they were playing up against SK earlier tonight, it was Mixwell and Tarek that looked really good on Train. And Mixwell, he wasn't hugely impressive on Nuke to me, so hopefully he'll be able to step up here on Train, maybe a little bit more at home on this map. We'll see how they do go about it, but OpTic, as expected, starting off on that T side, and they're going to want to be getting off to a good start as well, because they kind of are coming off a bit of a pummeling in that second half of Nuke, where they only got one round up against, what was it, like 11 from Cloud9. So
Something
the
like
momentum
that.
Is definitely in the favor of Cloud9 at this point.
Shroud gonna need to hit the shot here at Ivy, as there is a lot of players there waiting for him, and they will cross, spots out a couple, instead just falls back and waits around. OpTic, they were considering pushing that, but they spot one player there. No damage is exchanged, but they will be falling back off that while the rest of their players begin to move in through the upper halls. Stewie just waiting at the bottom of the ramp. Very common position you see in pistol rounds. Automatic, not as common of a position. Boosted on top of the... What is that? It's a ticket booth office thing?
Yeah.
Container?
It's a thing.
Box in the connector? I should know what that's called, but right now I'm blanking on it. Either way, he's going to be tucked in the little corner there. Not as common of a position to see in pistol rounds, but certainly one that OpTic will be waiting for. But... For now, they're moving over towards this B site, setting up to go out the lower ramp here, just waiting for their moment.
Oh, Crowd's already started off nicely, though. Mixwell goes down, Automatic picking up a kill there as well for Cloud9, and things are chugging along quite nicely after Nuke, it seems. They do want to pick up the pistol round, though, and they seem as though they should be able to do that. Naf, the only one at this point to get any kills for OpTic, and he's gotten two, but two is not enough. You need five. Cloud9, it's exactly what they've managed to do. So, starting off with the first pistol here on train, OpTic Gaming not getting the bomb down will result in what looks to be a pistol and arm buy. But just continuing that momentum rolling along through here for Cloud9 is a great start.
There we go, Naf will eventually buy. I was wondering if he was going to join his team. But yeah, Cloud9, they'll be happy with that. They'll be wanting to establish themselves and make their mark early on train. As they have to know that even though train is a decent map for them, it's a great one for OpTic. So they want to get started with as many rounds and as much damage done as they possibly can. It's a little hut thing, there you go, by the looks of it.
Yeah.
But yeah, they'll be wanting to make their mark here very early on to the damage. And indeed, they've already started off the right way with Rush taking a lot of damage. I believe that was from a grenade. Could also have been from a scout tag of Scooter. I didn't see exactly where that went down, but either way, good start from Cloud9. They just need to get this round nice and cleanly.
Yeah, that's exactly it. They need to try and probably only lose, I'd say, a single gun here, maybe two they could get away with, but they don't obviously want it to be automatic. They need to be a little bit careful there, but yeah, Cloud9 obviously want to be taking as many guns through to the next round as they can here. Shroud gets relatively low as well, so OpTic doing a decent job of actually putting some damage in, but not actually getting the kills just yet. And automatic has managed to find a second there with only 15 HP to work with, nothing covering him off as well. Naf does get one, could get a second, but not quite. So far, still for OpTic Gaming, Naf's the only one to pick up a frag so far on this map. Admittedly, it's only two rounds in, but I want to be seeing OpTic Gaming stepping up a little bit here.
3-0 and 2 for Naf. The only one on the board over on the Cloud9 side of things, nothing. 3-0. Stewie 3-1. Automatic 3-1. It seems that 3 kills is the order of the day in the server for these guys, but this one, no upgrades. Naf, care of those extra kills he has been getting, can grab a P250 over just going with Glocks like the rest of his team, but there is no utility, there is no armor, and Stewie's going to get aggressive for the kill on Mixwell, dancing around the pillar. He'll eventually take him down, gets a grenade in to follow as well, but falls back through the smoke as no one else is pressuring him, but when he goes back in, there's going to be more people there, and the dinks come in. Naf cleans up the first, keeping all the kills from his teammates. Will the rest of OpTic even get on the board in this round? Potentially not. Beautiful spray from Automatic there, finding three. That was a lovely spray transfer between Naf and Jason R. Hmm. But Naf's still the only one with kills.
Yeah, well, maybe this is going to change in this round because it is finally time for OpTic to get a buy on the board.
This sniper configuration is interesting. Oh, no, there we go. Scudetto had a scout while Stewie had an AWP, and I was going to question that, but the upgrade comes through.
Yeah, so it makes sense for Cloud9, but immediately the double AWP setup. I mean, that's very early on in the piece.
It is, but when OpTic really haven't been getting anything done, it's just Naf that's really been achieving anything so far in this game. Might as well go for it. They've got the money. They've been getting the kills. So Stewie just warming up his flicks over towards Ivy, ready to go either high or low. And both peaks come in, and he hits one, but the other gets the trade. That's the point of that double peak. That is exactly what OpTic were hoping to achieve there. So one of the orbs is down, but that's Stewie.
I suspect they would have been hoping to achieve a kill without any deaths. But again, one for one is about as good as you can get. And yeah, they do know that the double AWP is out. But again, it's just Cloud9 have got the advantage once more in this round.
Nothing. He's going to need to hit this shot if they actually drop on him. And they will. Spots out Jason R and tries to go back in for the dink, but doesn't get the kill. So Jason R now on the board as well. Kills starting to come in for the other members of OpTic.
But Molotov's good.
Molotov is excellent. Jason R going to have to fall back from that. Takes a bit of damage from it. The grenade is also perfect. Excellent Naf, utility usage.
Naf was burning in that Molotov as well, down to 28. So this is really just being exactly what you said. Excellent utility use from Cloud9. Skadoodle hits the shot as well. Rush does trade out one, but it's not going to be enough by the looks of things. Two versus one here for Rush to deal with. He does have a grenade, but he won't be able to pick up a kill with that. Going to have to rely on the aim from this point out. And Skadoodle is just going to go one better. Three kills in that round. Straight off the bat. Again, continuing that form with the AWP through from Nuke. Cloud9 are looking dangerous right now.
They have lost the double AWP, and there could be no upgrade there. I believe the FAMAS there could not get upgraded. There was no other guns for them to trade that out with. So the FAMAS will continue through, but
they could have afforded
Shroud
the double AWP in this round, actually. But
Shroud's back on the comfort gun.
Yeah.
Sitting on the AUG again.
I saw him tweet, and he said something about taking it through again to the map number two. And it's definitely worked out on Nuke, so why not? Why not, indeed?
Absolutely. If you're going to be able to hit heads with it, then just go for it. He was doming people in the last map, so might as well continue on with that trend, as it's only pistols from the OpTic guys here. They do have some armor, but they've got to try and win some very awkward long-range fights. Stewie could be caught out here, but I think he spotted the shoulder of Jason. Either that or that timing is just ridiculously lucky. So we'll be falling back, staying safe for now. Not throwing his grenade out either. But the pistols of OpTic have to get in so close unless these deagles can do work at long range.
Yeah, well, it does seem like it's going to be a fairly similar start to this map as what we saw the last, though the sides are going to be reversed. Cloud9 looking like they might start off with a 5-0. See, though, maybe this pistol round does go the way of OpTic. That's nicely played from Tag, just peeking in and out, taking the advantage over Automatic. He's got a gun in his hands now as well. We'll see what he can do with it. Maybe enough, because he's been able to take down nothing. He's playing very, very close to Shroud, but Shroud, he finds two and equalizes the player advantage. Now he actually gives the player advantage to Cloud9 by picking up that third. He's going to find
the
four
ace, Shroud.
And not quite getting the ace, but Skadoodle still closing it out for Cloud9. And I'm not too disappointed by that. Again, the FAMAS not upgraded by Cloud9, but oh well. Five rounds on the board. Economy, it's starting to build up. It's not getting there just yet, but looking good for Cloud9 so far on that CT side.
It is. The Org of Shroud doing work again. He's 6-1 at the moment. Clearly, all that expertise playing H1 and new Battlegrounds game with the scoped weapons carrying over. Gets himself lots of kills. It's an interesting smoke from Skadoodle. I'm actually not sure where that hits, but either way, he's going to be throwing that out. The rest of his team. The buy is a bit mixed from them. I do still have Stewie on that FAMAS, and there's full AKs out for the OpTic guys, but given how Shroud's been looking, he could do this the majority of the work by himself.
Yeah, definitely. Although, maybe not against the guns. Last round was against pistols. This time OpTic with some weapons to work with, and again, fairly similar setup to what they had in the first gun round, where they did have two over towards Ivy. They were peeking in, but this time no AWP to challenge them there from Stewie. It's actually Shroud holding that angle with the AWG.
OpTic, though, still aren't really pushing. They've got themselves some positions. They're up in the halls. They're over towards Ivy. They've got the bomb still back in team main, but they haven't really moved anywhere, and they don't need to. Well, they do need to, but they don't need to rush. They can take their time. On the side of Cloud9, they really just need to sit back and wait. They don't need to get aggressive. They did try it. They've had the FAMAS push up into the upper halls a couple times to try and get some information, but they don't need to be doing that. They just need to sit back, wait for OpTic to come to them, and then try and win those aim jewels. And for now, looks like it's going to be a late flank through Ivy for OpTic, with the main push going in towards the B side. There we go, the grenades do come out. And Molotov going to block off Mixwell, so he can't quite move perhaps as far as he would want to. But the rest of his team, they're going over towards B. This is all just a fake in Ivy.
Cloud9 pretty much perfectly set up to defend that, though. Mixwell does take down Automatic, so good start for OpTic here, but only 20 seconds left, and they do need to get the bomb down. Stewie's just going to deny that. I think that's the round over here for OpTic, although the kill does go the way of NAF, and that might open things up enough for NAF to get the bomb down, because Skadoodle is quite far back in the site, although we do have a wraparound coming from the back for Cloud9. Oh, he might have just got that in time. Yeah, he does, but it's not going to matter. NAF should go down here. Nothing does drop, but NAF's down on 9 HP now. And two players to deal with. Unless he...
Oh, no.
Well, okay.
This is interesting now.
Oh.
All right, well. Easy shot for Skadoodle.
That's kind of the whack-a-mole analogy coming out once again.
It is. Boop, surprise. But Skadoodle with the 3K in the round to save his team there. NAF made that one a lot more interesting than it perhaps had to be. And that's going to be a lot of guns that are going to need to be rebought from Cloud9. But
they've got the money.
Exactly, they've got the money. And that was a good buy out of OpTic as well. Shroud. I was about to say, does he have enough to go for the AWG? Of course he does. Needs to keep that thing up.
Yeah.
Who needs M4s in this day and age when you can just have a scope and win? Evidently not Shroud, so the T is going to be buying once again. Full AKs, decent utility out, full armor. Actually, very good utility. They've got lots of smokes, lots of Molotovs. If they can get the bomb down in that same spot on B, they have the Molotovs now to be able to defend it with that easy post-plant molly off the door, which I think I've seen pretty much no players miss.
Yeah, and that rebuy that Cloud9 had to take there has really drained their economy quite a lot. So OpTic, if they can win this round, they might be able to string a couple together on the back of some anti-ecos. But they will need to win this round, and so far they've... I mean, yes, it was a 1v1 last round, but, like, was it really that close? I don't think so. So it doesn't seem to me as though OpTic are really having much of an impact on Cloud9 right now on that T side.
Not as much. Let's try and change that going forward. This could be the round in which they do it, but just look at the rate in which they're burning through the utility. There's a minute and 6 seconds-ish left on the clock. They've already thrown out half of their flashbangs, a couple of those Molotovs. They've still got all their smokes, but they're burning through utility, and most of that was just utility to deny Cloud9 peeking them. They haven't really pushed anywhere with it. They're still all in the default T-control areas of the map. They haven't taken anywhere away from Cloud9 just yet. As their utility, Jason R is completely out. They're running so low, and they haven't really used any of it to get anywhere.
Molotov into uppers for Cloud9. OpTic are playing very, very slowly so far on the T side. If this one doesn't work out in their way, it might be time to change things up, but we'll see how this goes. Automatic, he spots the bomb out there as well. That's really, really early information for Cloud9. The rotations should come across a Molotov as well, just to deny the bomb retrieval, or at least make it a little bit more difficult. And at this point, Cloud9 seem in a good position, though the trades are actually going the way of OpTic. 2v1 now for Skadoodle. 16 seconds left, though, for OpTic, and if they don't get this bomb down, well, Tarrant going down is going to make life even more difficult here for Rush. He knows exactly where Skadoodle is, and Skadoodle missed the shot. It's a round on the board for OpTic, but oh, it was a bit of a streaky one.
It was, and the bomb not going down means that their economy not going to get that little bit of an extra boost. Of course, winning the round will do enough for them, but they're only going to be able to save one gun from the coffers of Cloud9. But speaking of the coffers of Cloud9, that money running pretty low for them. This is just going to be a pistol round, so their money finally broken. Nothing has a Zeus. I'd love to see a kill with that. But on the side of OpTic, it's still not a great buy. Their utility is limited. They've got Tarik stuck on a Galil, but the rest of their team are going to be pretty happy. And if they can kill, if they can clean up this anti-eco and they're losing a kill or two, really, they should be fine, but nothing. I'd love Nath to drop down there right now. I love Zeus kills.
Yeah, I'm a big fan as well.
Well, Cloud9 had that period in the summer where they just only used Zeus's back when they were made, you know, very, very cheap. Cloud9 just bought them forever.
Oh, when they were free.
Yeah, that's, yeah, when in that update, which was terribly broken, Shroud not be able to close out on Rush. So that's a good start in this anti-eco. Rush picking himself up too. The Zeus on nothing's still alive, but he can hear. All these players are running away from them as he looks dejectedly through the wall. Oh, guys, come party this way. This is where all the fun is. I've got streamers.
OpTic Gaming are apparently the party poopers in this analogy.
Evidently.
Yeah, nothing. Remember the streamers. That was a good time.
That was good. Yeah, free Zeus's was just... There's been montages made. I believe there was enough kills in them to go for 3 minutes or more of just Cloud9 getting Zeus kills. Oh, nothing. Nothing is full committing. He wants this.
He was close.
He got close. Jason R shuts him out, though. So a clean anti-ego from OpTic Gaming. That's what they needed to get further into this. The money has restabilized from Cloud9 such that they could buy, but they could also just take a double eco here and bring out a much better buy in the next round.
Oh, they're not going to go for the double eco. They're going to force into it.
No Orc for Shroud.
No Orc, but they do have the AWP on Skadoodle, and a rifle for at least nothing and automatic. Oh, and I guess Shroud has got it from us, so that counts as a rifle as well. But, yeah, not too many utilities here, and OpTic starting to get the ball rolling just a little bit. If Cloud9 do lose this round, then I think things are becoming a little bit of a problem for them. I would have liked to see that double eco, but it doesn't seem to be the done thing anymore, really. Pretty much everyone is just forcing into the rounds when they can buy.
Might as well go for it. You've got to get something on the board, but OpTic looking to pinch into this A side. They've got players everywhere. The smoke going to come and pop in Nath's face. He's not going to push through it. Skadoodle does find the first kill, but very quick movement. Nothing, though, at E-Box. He's found himself one, but has to worry about being wrapped off from everywhere. He's going to take down Nath, though. That's sharp from him. Shroud's going to get a kill, too, and now Mixwell, one on four, has to worry about nothing. He knows he was close. Nothing's going to peek straight into him. Mixwell hits the shot, but the dink... Actually, no, that was through the wall. Does pretty much no damage at all. Mixwell, though, still has to try and clutch out a one-on-three. Has enough time to make it over to B if that's where he decides to go. But right now, that's a pretty predictable move. He's got to try and fake out Cloud9.
Yeah. Faking out Cloud9, not going to be the easiest of tasks. But at least he's got the bomb, right? So he's got enough to work with here. He's got an AK as well. So that's, I suppose, in this kind of a situation, an upgrade.
Stewie up high, though. Should be able to find the angle of Mixwell as he sneaks down the side of these trains. Mixwell looking for a fight. Stewie will spot him. Kill comes through, easy as you like. Upgrades the AK-47 that Mixwell was kind enough to bring him. And
deliver
Shroud,
it.
Exactly, to express. Shroud is still stuck on that FAMAS, but the rest of his team have enough guns that they'll be able to get some buys out. On the side of OpTic, though, they've got an AWP dropped over to Mixwell. They have three AKs and a UMP out. This is just Force Buy versus Force Buy right now.
Yeah, well, OpTic, if they can win this and reset the economy again of Cloud9, there's probably potential for a couple more rounds going in their favor. But in saying that, Cloud9 have looked so very good on the CT side here. And seven rounds up against the two. I guess this half is still, in a sense, hanging in the balance, but you have to give the advantage to Cloud9 at this point.
Exactly. They've already found themselves seven more. They need one more to actually win the half. They'll be looking to go further after that if they can. But first thing they're going to need to do is win this round so that they can get their money a little bit more stabilized, get some more rounds going over OpTic Gaming. And given that this is one of OpTic's comfort maps, that's what Cloud9 will be looking to do. They want to give themselves the best advantage they can early on.
Automatic just watching down the angle past the blue trains. Or just the blue train. Hasn't spotted much. Oh, what an angle.
That's incredibly tight. It's the angle of dreams right there, boys. That's what we're looking for.
I think Mixwell might have just been spotted out. But OpTic, they seem to be very, very committed to this A bomb site right now. They've got all their players there except for the one that's going to die, which is Jason R. So that's, you know, caught napping a little bit, I suppose.
Yeah, I wasn't really expecting the push there, which is unfortunate. He was just ready to throw out. By the looks of things, setting up throw through grenades over towards that B site, try and fake out some of Cloud9. But Cloud9 right now, their mental fortitude is very strong. They're just sitting here like, nope, we're not going to be faked. That's one guy. Cool. We think you're still coming A. Now the rotate is coming, but Cloud9 have called this in a 5-on-4. They've got some players over here to deal with this.
Skadoodle with the AWP down the bottom of the B bomb site. There's a player at the nothing actually at the Z connector. Skadoodle opens things up. Nothing finding another one. And the actual B player himself, Stewie, doesn't even need to do anything.
Gets shut out by the rest of his team.
Thanks, boys.
No worries, lads.
Easy day on the job.
Cheers, guys. I'll just put my feet up and put my feet up on the desk, grab a coffee, chill out, have a good time.
Feet up on the desk is the dream. Totally not what I'm doing right now.
Definitely not. The double AWP comes out for Cloud9 though. Skadoodle and automatic with those actually. Usually it's Stewie with the secondary AWP, but this time automatic. Feeling it, with it. And on the side of OpTic Gaming, there's a P250 on Naf again, and it's Glocks for the rest of his team. Last time we saw this, Naf got a kill, and then everyone else died, so potentially a repeat performance, but Stewie with the AK spots out Naf. Just gonna wait. Time is smoke, throw it, fall back. Doesn't need to worry. They're not pushing.
Yeah, I mean, it's a bit of a nothing buy, really, for OpTic, so this should be another round
for
Cloud9.
Nothing's on Cloud9, mate.
Hey?
Nothing's on Cloud9.
Ha-ha! That was a terrible joke.
Thanks, man. I worked hard on it. I'm glad you're proud of me.
I thought we weren't allowed to have fun on this broadcast. You trying to have fun?
What's fun? Not what OpTic are having, that's for sure, especially as Naf loses his shins to the AWP. That's got to not be a fun time. That would hurt.
It would.
And, well,
Skadoodle was a bit late.
Potentially caught with his pants down here, but we'll be able to fall back, hold an angle again. Although, Mixwell going to be able to find a kill with the Glock and upgrade to an AK, but with no armor to back that thing up, should be aim punched. There we go. He will fall. Rush goes down as well. And now Jason R. We've seen some clutches before with a Glock would be particularly nutty as actually we'll get one and an AWP, but doesn't get a chance to use it. The double AWP can be recovered. Shroud should grab that thing. There we go. Get rid of that from us. Nothing can upgrade to an AK if he so chooses. And that's going to be Cloud9 with their ninth round.
OpTic only with two. I think OpTic will be able to get a buy here in this round. They did just eco the last one. So let's have a look and see what their economy is looking like. Yep, more than enough to afford a buy. And a pause coming out as well. I know what that music means. Tack pause! OpTic Gaming, they needed it.
Is that like a Batman style thing you were going for?
Well,
I was
actually just trying to mimic the current song, but it actually kind of did turn into a bit of a Batman.
It did a little bit. Well, OpTic, they're going to need a superhero to save the day, given that they're down seven rounds. 9-2 is the score. Cloud9 looking very, very good on really what we would have said is OpTic's place, OpTic's home, somewhere they're really comfortable on.
I mean, we haven't seen OpTic yet on the CT side, so maybe they come back into that. I guess we don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves because we're in danger of doing that on Nuke as well.
We are, but Cloud9 are also getting quite far ahead of OpTic.
Yes, that's true. Nine rounds. I guess right now OpTic at this point probably just hoping to get to probably five or six. I'd say five would be like sort of a reasonable point to hit. Anything less, six would be better, obviously, but anything less than five. And OpTic are going to really struggle in that second half.
If they get 11-4 or worst case scenario 12-3, 13-2, it's not looking good for them going further into trainers. Cloud9, they're usually decent on their T side. They had a time, they had a period when I think nothing was calling it. They had some real struggles on their T side, but that has mostly passed now. They've been a lot more consistent on the T side. I think it's Stewie calling for them now. Maybe automatic and Shroud has the classic org out again. He's actually getting aggressive here. Does the damage on Tarek and does not care at all. Going to keep pushing here, looking for more kills. This is ridiculous aggression from Cloud9. Shroud
needs to be careful.
Time to get a reload in, but we'll fall back into a Molotov. Mixwell wants to pressure.
The timing.
That actually works out for Cloud9, but it's a one for one. They maybe would have wanted some more from that. It's a nice Molotov into automatic position, but again, Cloud9, they've got the confidence up now. You're going to Molotov us? Great. We're going to get aggressive. Good luck.
Yeah, and they know that OpTic has been talking about what's going on here on the CT side. So feels to me as though Cloud9 are changing things up in relation to that, but it's clearly not worked out there. OpTic with their most convincing round so far of the second map. Four players left alive. Still not too big of a deal here for Cloud9. They should be able to buy into this one, assuming nothing is going to drop for Stewie, which he does.
The problem in that round, though, for Cloud9 was the aggression. They pushed into the B halls early on. They get a one-for-one trade. They fall back. But then we saw it was, I believe, Automatic, who was stuck by that Molotov, pushed forward on the train. Doing that, gave up Ivy controller. T's flanking through there. I think it was Rush came in, got himself one or two kills. The aggression from Cloud9, aggression is fine, but you can't give up your default hold by doing so. And when they pushed in that round, they gave up Ivy controller, had the flank to come through. OpTic just wrapped into the site, and every Cloud9 member who died shooting at one person and being shot from behind. The crossfire was just perfect from OpTic.
Yeah, but how's Cloud9 going to react? Because if they take this round away, they can just storm through with the first half here. But if they don't, and they start to let OpTic get back into this one, obviously next round for a Cloud9 should be an eco. You know, that's sort of five rounds there for OpTic Gaming. So this round, very, very important for both of the teams. It can result in a couple more rounds in a row to whichever team gets the win.
You can see, though, Cloud9 this time not being as aggressive at all. They've made sure to keep an anchor down towards Ivy at Shroud this time. They're not letting themselves get flanked out now. They're not playing as aggressive into A Mania. They don't have as much information as they did. But what just happened to them? Surely, if I can figure it out, they can figure it out. They're actually good players, and they'll be able to adapt to that. They don't want it to happen again. But Naf, undercover of these smokes, actually worked his way out. There's a few players there getting out from team main, moving in towards E-Box. The rest of these players playing around these smokes, nothing in a great position here behind the red train. That's one of the few positions that doesn't actually get hit by the standard flashes and Molotovs, but he will be hit by a bullet in the face, and that's not the greatest of starts for him. Skadoodle. Okay, he was in connector. I thought he hit that shot dropping off the ladder there. But it's 3-on-4 for the retake.
It is looking a bit better now for OpTic once more in this round. Shroud still with the AUG. What can he do? Hasn't been quite as impactful with that weapon as he was on Nuke. And Stewie, he's going to peek out Mixwell. I don't know if he wasn't watching the angle. I thought
Guess
he was.
Not.
But
might have been watching low connector.
Easy kill for Stewie. And now Shroud, he's got a job to do. He's got two players in his sight lines. Oh, almost gets the second one there onto Jason R, but it's just Rush now.
Noodle sticking this. Tarek hasn't heard it.
All right, Tarek, not Rush. Yeah, and Tarek, he should be able to clutch this out now. I think the time has gone a little bit too far.
If there was a kid on Skadoodle, that was over. But as it is, Stewie just has to bow out of the round. He really wants this kill. Does damage to Tarek, and Tarek dies to the bomb. So Stewie does enough, but the round is won by OpTic regardless. However, Cloud9 really got the optimal situation. They did as much damage as they possibly could while still losing the round. But the money on OpTic is such that they can rebuy, and Cloud9, really, they can either choose to force and try and rally behind the AK on Stewie, or just take a save and hope that Stewie can do something ridiculous.
They have to save, surely.
Yeah, they will.
Maybe Stewie can push the B halls again, like what we've seen him do. Actually, it looks like he's headed towards the A bomb site, so he's typically been the B player so far for Cloud9. This time, changing things up, and I think that's fair enough. When you're on a buy like this, you just need to be making things a little bit more difficult for OpTic, making them think, and perhaps catching them off guard, because you play standard, you're just going to get out-dueled. It'll be so easy for OpTic in that situation, but doing what he needs to do.
Not quite. What he needed there was a kill, but makes himself known as to fall back, dodges the flashbang, spots the shoulder peek there. OpTic playing very dangerous games with their lives, but Stewie eventually runs out of ammo, gets taken out by Mixwell. That is the AK gone. Shroud can potentially get one onto Rush here, but Rush, very aware of this corner being a possibility, should check it, and Shroud not even going to land a shot. So now it's the rest of the pistols. P250's no armor. Can maybe do some damage. Naf could go down here. He's in a bit of a terrible angle. That's the bomb too. So that's potentially a problem. There's actually two AKs been upgraded for Skadoodle and Automatic as well. But there's a terrorist coming in through from behind him. It's going to be Tarek wrapping all the way through CT. That flank should be enough to close this one out.
Automatic though does manage to take down Rush. And is the flank going to be enough? Because Skadoodle has spotted it out. The bomb's still well in the control of Cloud9, and 35 seconds left to work with
There's
for OpTic Gaming.
Too.
They need to move quickly here.
They do. They've got to try and figure this one out, and it's Jason coming in from the upper halls, and Tarek, well, was behind, and now Jason has clutched it out. Does have armor, so aim punch. Not going to be an issue for him, but he's got 20 seconds. He needs to find these shots, and he's not going to. Automatic.
Even if he had, would he have even been able to get the bomb down in time?
Unless Skadoodle was doing some ridiculous, like, very aggressive peek that allowed Jason to find that angle, there was nothing he was getting done there. So Cloud9 get the eco win just after I said they shouldn't, just to prove me wrong.
Yep.
They get three AKs through from it. They're going to buy an AWP onto Skadoodle and an M4 on Stewie to complete that buy. And over on the side of OpTic, it's two AKs, three Tech Nines. This worked for Cloud9 last round. A worse buy actually worked for Cloud9 last round, but it's so much easier to force and win on the CT side than it is on the T in general. Because you can sit in a close angle and wait for players to come to you. On the T side, you got to move. You got to go find them.
Right. OpTic, looks like this time they're going to try and control Ivy. They're trying to hope to close this out at 10-5, but Cloud9 well in the position to be able to turn this into 11 rounds on the CT side, which is pretty much where they would have been happy to sit.
That's what they would like.
Yep, so push coming out from OpTic Gaming. The flashbang will be good for Shroud, and it completely turns Mixwell into nothing, really.
To
trade mind. Out, though.
Indeed, it's good at all. Not going to go for the push through that smoke. Ooh, I don't think he spotted Naf there. Should have an idea now. Nothing. Taking the duel with Tarik through this smoke. Looking for it. Tarik just going to push straight through and will fall. Nothing. Almost hit the 180 there. But now Rush left all on his own. Has two kills in this round. Going to need to double that to close this out. Nothing in automatic. Really just crossfired. The bomb is sitting behind Skadoodle right now, who's holding a very tight angle. And even if Skadoodle misses and gets taken down here, automatic sitting up in heaven has Overwatch on this bomb site. And with 35 seconds left, there's really, unless Rush moves out, gets this kill and grabs the bomb, now he has no time to go B. So automatic can just wait.
And it's going to hit the shot. Easy kill for him. 11 rounds in the first half for Cloud9. The tables have turned from Nuke, where OpTic came through with 10. Now it's Cloud9 with 11, moving over to their own T side. And feels like that's enough to me.
If Cloud9 can win the pistol, this is done, basically. Yep. If they can't, there's a chance for OpTic to be able to force their way back into this a little bit, but Cloud9, they're usually pretty good in the pistol rounds. Unless Jason R can just show up very, very strong. It's because he's really the main... He's not the only pistol player on OpTic, but from what I've seen of him, he's very, very strong on the pistols. So if he can show up, if the rest of their players can do that, if Naf, we saw him be good on the pistols early on in the first half, he was really the only one getting kills for three rounds, I think. If they can do that, they can get the pistol, they can start to mount a comeback. If Cloud9 can just roll on through and shut them out, then they'll be shut out. It'll be over.
Well, that's really going to be the key here, isn't it, for them? They need to start off with the pistol, but not only that, are they going to need to then turn this into a bit more of a game where they kind of seem to be having any kind of an impact? Because really, on the T side there was like maybe two or three rounds where they looked actually all that good. I think in particular, I'm looking for Tarik and Mixwell to step up. Mixwell, particularly with that AWP, going to be very, very impressive if he can be able to turn things around here on the CT side of train. But he's a key player for me here. Cloud9, if they just close that pistol out, like you said, very tough for OpTic to come back into this one. Cloud9 quickly out into the A side as well.
Great utility usage to get in, but Rush finding two. Good work from him. Tarik finds third as well. Automatic will trade at least one back, but Skadoodle now left on his own. And catch out Tarik here. Hits the first shot, but needs three more. The bomb is down. The P comes in from Naf. There's no armor on Skadoodle either, and he will fall. So a great pistol round from OpTic there. Good work from Rush, getting face down by multiple players to take down two before falling. Gives them a chance for... Gives OpTic a chance to try and fight back into this a little bit. Still a fair way down, but they will be able to buy now, although Mixwell coming in with an M4. There we go. The rest of the buys come out. Naf with a mag 7.
Double scout from Cloud9.
That's interesting as well. Stewie and Skadoodle taking those. I just want to try and find some headshots if they can. Or if they can hit the 70 tags under the body with the scouts, the deagles are one-shot kills.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they're going for here.
Skadoodle already tagged down just a little bit. So at this point, it would be thought that OpTic should know that this buy is coming out for Cloud9. Automatic started off nicely, though.
That's the M4 down as well.
Cloud9 have actually been very good at their eco rounds so far tonight.
They've been playing
it's
well.
It's a dangerous sort of a situation right now for OpTic Gaming, because even though they should, in theory, be favored to get this win, doesn't necessarily mean that's going to be the case, especially considering the initial pick goes the way of Cloud9. That's how you slowly start to snowball around like this. You get the pick, maybe you can find the gun, maybe you can't, but the pick's still good. Nice shot, though, from Rush. Automatic had no chance.
So Cloud9 now with two scouts and two deagles have to try and make this round work. Rush, dropping off the train, finds himself another headshot there. Skadoodle has fallen. And now, wow. Okay, Rush was peeking over the train. I thought he was actually falling off there when he hit that, but a perfect peek. Stewie does find one with the scout, getting a nice crisp headshot through, and Stewie walks straight into Rush there, getting his second kill of the round, this time with the deagle. You know, 2-on-2 though. Tarik playing the other side of the smoke. Has a lot to do as Nap is quite far away. 25 seconds now on the clock. Not much time for Cloud9 to really work with. Naf going to be in a pretty rough position here, and Tarik getting double picked will fall. Now Naf, 18 seconds. The
only
bomb
the
has
mag
to go
seven
down on A, but the mag 7 is a very, very close range weapon.
It is, but he's not going to be able to use it at this range unless he sneaks all the way around the bomb train. They actually just double peek him. The bomb's going to probably be planted. Nope, Stewie decides. Oh, Shroud rather decides. Nope, no worries. Anyway, Cloud9. Cloud9, get the pistol in. And OpTic are on the eco. Slash force buy, by the looks of things, but... Gee, that's not how you wanted to start off the second half here, OpTic. Well, it was, because they got the pistol, but...
That's how they wanted to start, but not continue.
Didn't follow it up.
No. Which is a shame, because that really could be their chances in the bin of coming back into this. Early days in this half, they can still do some more here, but Cloud9, their anti-ecos have generally been pretty good. So if they can take this one through, if they can get this without losing too many guns, I mean, really, the only guns they care about right now is Stewie. Stewie's AK. That's what they worry about losing. Of course, they don't want to lose four other guns, but Skadoodle's just on a Tech 9. He can do whatever he wants. Stewie is actually going to swap out the AK to Shroud, given that health disadvantage. Go back to the Scout, which he had good impact with last round, so fair enough. The AK is all they're really worried about losing. The rest of it, the Scout, was kept from last round. One of those UMPs was kept from last round. The only thing they've really invested in is another UMP in an AK-47. So if they can keep just those alive, they'll be set.
You would think so. OpTic need to find something in this round, though, because they cannot allow any more rounds to bleed over to Cloud9. They've given up too much already in this second half by losing that anti-eco. That now Cloud9 is really in pole position just to close this one out with an extremely significant scoreline. They've already had okay results on train so far this season with the 16-9 over Immortals. Obviously, this 16-5 over Complexity as well. And they might be just on track to do something very, very similar right now against OpTic. But let's not count our chickens before they hatch. OpTic finding their first kill on the round, but the B site now fully in control. Cloud9.
And Automatic getting very, very aggressive with his UMP as well. Cutting off the connector at the pass. Shroud will step up and finish off Tarek there and these other guys running straight through the smoke. Going to go square into the UMP. Automatic finds two. And Rush should be following shortly. Automatic with his third. Good money from the UMP. Good damage. Cloud9 take 13.
Alrighty. That's going to be another eco here for OpTic Gaming. So they have to save for next round. They can force buy into the next one. But Cloud9 are really just... There's not much more to say, really. They're just rolling over OpTic at this point. Well and truly.
It's basically all it is, yeah. Just rolling on through. And Cloud9 very, very aggressive here. Do not care about OpTic at all in this round. Just going to go in, put the hurt, make it personal. Mixwell tapping away with the USP. Has been found out on this bomb train. Wants to stay alive, but... Gonna be, well, there we go. UMPs come through. Stewie, nothing close it out. 14 rounds for Cloud9. One gun lost. Good money from the UMPs.
That Cloud9 snowball is sort of three quarters of the way down the hill. It's pretty much picked up the maximum speed that it wants to get to. It's as big as it's going to get. And they're going to turn into an avalanche sooner or later by the looks of things.
Essentially.
OpTic Gaming, though, with the buy. It's a little lackluster, but it's there. Just missing some utilities. One defuse kit only as well, so Rush is going to be key here. If he goes down on the wrong bomb site or something like that, then OpTic may be in a spot of bother in a post-plant sort of a situation, but that would mean Cloud9 have to get the bomb down. And as of yet, that's not the case. OpTic with a bit of a push here as well, courtesy of Mixwell. I think there's another play with him.
Yeah, Tarek just boosted up. I was going to ask what that was, but it was Tarek's boots. And Tarek, moving around here, could actually... potentially find himself a nice position.
This is a lot of information, though, for OpTic.
It is.
They know pretty much exactly where Cloud9 is. They know that Cloud9 is setting up now for an A take.
And Tarek, he could potentially come all the way through behind him here, Skadoodle. He hasn't been spotted, but nothing will be. Tarek biding his time. The trigger control so perfect. If Skadoodle checks, as Tarek's done, but he's looking for the kills. Finds one, finds two. He's going to go for it, finds both, and the bomb as well. Cloud9, you have to be aware of that, and this round is falling apart for them. Skadoodle will kill Tarek, retake the bomb, but he has to do it all himself and can't find another kill.
Yeah.
Cloud9, you can't give up that sort of map control.
That cannot happen at all. I thought Skadoodle maybe was probably the one that needed to be watching that angle. I think there's going to be some stern words going on in the Cloud9 camp after that round. But look, it's not the end of the world. They still have so many rounds to play with. OpTic only six on the board now. Cloud9, the ones with 14, and they will be able to afford a buy into this one. So OpTic Gaming, despite winning that round, their buy again, it's not perfect. It's maybe a little better. No AWP, they do have it from us, lacking some defuse kits and utilities as well.
Shroud's back on the scoped gun. This time not the AUG. Got the Krieg out. Didn't have as much effect with this over on Nuke, but might be able to do some clicking of heads here. It allows him to just get a little bit of a closer range or a closer view on those long range angles if he can take that fight. Looks like he's actually walking into B by himself, walking into the upper halls by himself. Looking to clear some angles, so. For OpTic, it's a pretty heavy A stack. They put four players over there. Mixwell is now rotating over through the connector to join NAF, so standard, more standard play for them. One player towards Ivy, two on A, two on B. It's what we're normally used to seeing. There's some aggressive positions on A, actually. Tarek looking to push in. Shroud needs to get this kill, and he will. Nothing gets one as well. So now OpTic, they're walking. Beautiful shots from Automatic.
Absolutely.
Mixwell could go the same way. Well, indeed. Beautiful headshots from Automatic. Stewie finds Jason R, so. What looks like a little bit of life coming into OpTic has been stomped out of them again, as this one's a pistol by Cloud9. They just need to play slow, play their map control. They can't let someone like Tarek flank them again. But if they just take this one slowly, play their map control, get their frags, this is done 16-6.
Alrighty, well, Cloud9, they're in a good spot here. Like, what's OpTic Gaming going to be able to do realistically with just the pistols? Cloud9 really looking good on this T side as well. They've only dropped one or two rounds. Stewie does open up on a Tarek. Jason R does trade one back at least there for OpTic, so it's still even player numbers for the moment, but not for too much longer as we now find ourselves with only two CTs left alive. NAF could be crucial here, but he should have been heard by Shroud in the end though. Shroud does go down, almost denies the bomb plan, and actually does take down Skadoodle, but in the end there's just too many numbers for Cloud9 left alive, and Stewie closes it out. So 16-6, the result on the second map there. Cloud9, once again, the victors. A 2-0 for them tonight.
Getting themselves a 2-0 over OpTic, which is not what I was predicting, but it was definitely closer than what you were predicting, which I believe was sort of tentatively a 2-0 for OpTic.
Tentatively, yeah.
But either way, Cloud9 will win it out. Very well played from them as well.
Yeah, really, really nice from Cloud9. They looked far and away the better team tonight. There was really only like that first half of Nuke where OpTic looked like they were probably the ones that were stronger tonight. So ever since then, it's been Cloud9 for days.
Yeah, well, for day, really, yeah, just today. Day. But they did enough. They got it done. They played very, very well. Their CT sides in particular were great. Their T sides were not possible. Bad. Their T sides were good enough to be able to capitalize on the work they did on their CT side, or to set themselves up to do enough work on their CT side. And that's what they did.
Yeah, definitely a great night for Cloud9. We'll have a look at how things went for them. 16-11 on the first map, as I said, 16-6 on the second, both the way of Cloud9, and no surprises over on the mainstream either. SK able to get a 1-1 with OpTic. I think that's a fairly, maybe not hugely expected result. I suppose you could say 2-0 for SK, but it's one that you can understand.
And it is, and that second game.
The second game, like that's
expected, yeah. But it hurts. Still hurts.
It still hurts, but it is expected. So.
They're Kiwis. We have no affiliation with them. Of course. They've got a majority New Zealand core, so we can just be like, oh, no.
Yeah, let's do that.
It's the rule for Australian teams overseas. They're Australian if they win and North American if they don't.
That's
or
it.
New Zealand or wherever we can assign them to. But expected results. And then Cloud9, maybe not as expected to get the 2-0 over OpTic. We're expecting at least one map for them, but they'll be very happy with the 2-0 going forward.
Yeah, let's find out what's going on tomorrow as well. Do have a bit of a stream going on here for us tomorrow too. NRG up against Renegades. And I guess we're getting the second map of Renegades and Liquid. Okay, that's news to me, but...
There you go.
There you go.
Fair enough. Triple Renegades, triple Aussie team for the Aussie stream
that
tomorrow,
was the one that sort of ended at like 13-13 or something.
Yeah, it might have been some server issues or something.
Yeah, so maybe we get to see the end of
that. We might just get the last six rounds of that, or five rounds of
that. That'll be good.
That'll be interesting, but there you go. It's an all-Australian affair, at least on one side of the stream, on one side of one of the teams. There we go. That's what I'm going for on the Australian stream tomorrow. So we'll be looking for, of course, as very unbiased casters, we'll be looking for Renegades to get some work done.
Very, very unbiased.
Oh, naturally. But there you go. It's going to be good.
It is going to be good. And today was good as well. Look, I mean, I thought that was a really good matchup to be able to watch. Cloud9, they're going to be very pleased with how that one's gone. OpTic, maybe not so much, but at least they got the win over SK earlier on tonight. So it's not an entirely terrible night for them. But overall, 1-3 for OpTic. They would have been coming into tonight hoping for a little bit better.
They would have. They would have liked a little bit more if they could have, especially after playing on Train, which is, as we said multiple times, one of their maps. They played against SK, who are arguably one of the best teams in the world, and they managed to get the win. 16-14, but a win regardless. So to then fall against one of their North American brethren in Cloud9 is a bit of a disappointing result for them, but it just shows the good form that Cloud9 are really bringing to this North American Pro League.
Yeah, we'll have to see how they continue to go throughout the rest of the season of NA Pro League. But for now, we are going to have to bid you good night. That's the end of our show for tonight. We will be back tomorrow at the regular time. Until then, have a good one.